Good afternoon and welcome into UNCG Spartan Baseball Stadium as Matt Frisbee set to take the hill for game two of today's doubleheader. UNCG comes into today's contest at 7-7. They're opposed by a 1-5 Princeton team. Frisbee on the mound, a 0.43 ERA, 3-0 in three appearances, 21 innings pitched, about 7 per game, 10 hits, 1 run. That 1 run was earned, 2 walks, 16 Ks, and opponents are batting 139 against the right-handed option. Digging in for Princeton as leadoff hitter is the left fielder, number 8, Chris Davis, a 0.77 average, a freshman. And the first pitch he sees is outside corner, but outside just a little bit too far for ball one. So 1-0 the count here to Chris Davis. The rest of the lineup looks like this. Batting second, Danny Baer. Batting third, Zach Bolesky. Batting fourth and cleaning things up, Nick Hernandez, the right fielder. Batting fifth and playing the DH role today, Connor Nolan. Batting sixth and playing third base, Joseph Flynn. Batting seventh and playing second base, Cody Phillips, as that one's popped up and out of play. Batting eighth and catching today, Max West. And rounding out the lineup, Asher Lee Tyson playing shortstop for the Tigers. Tigers pitcher is right-handed option, Ben Gross. A 0-0-0 ERA, one appearance, one game started. That's going to be grounded out to third baseman and scooped up, and underneath of it is Tripp Shelton, not in time. Though I thought Webster had a play on it. Just went under his glove. Luckily, Shelton was there to prevent extra bases. Good play there from Shelton. And that'll bring up Danny Baer. The 231 average, three hits and 13 tries for the Tigers. We'll see a replay here as it just goes right underneath the glove of Webster. Webster actually knocked it down a little bit. Shelton able to corral it, just not able to get the throw there in time. Spartans looking to sweep this doubleheader. They won the first game earlier today. That pitch catch that outside corner, strike one. A phenomenal pitching performance from Bryce Hensley as he racked up 13 Ks in the win. Frisbee settles and pitches inside. That ball gets away from the catcher, Ryan Clinch. The runner will advance on a wild pitch. Good heads-up base running by Davis to take second base on the wild pitch. We'll get you the defensive alignment as soon as we can. Still working on that. Our stat broadcast side of things. Just a little slow internet. Nothing the world can't fix. So 1-1 count here in favor of nobody. The outside pitch moves in favor of the hitter, Baer. Baer on the year only has one extra base hit. That was a double. He does have one RBI on the season as well. If he hits a double here, it will be an RBI. That pitch will be high for ball three. So 3-1 count here to Bayer. Defensive lineup will get you that as soon as this next pitch takes place. 3-1 count here. It's pretty much almost the same as it was in the first game. If you were with my comrade Dan Walker earlier today, you already know what it is. That's going to be a five-pitch walk to put a runner on first and second. No outs here in the bottom of, or excuse me, the top of the first. The defensive lineman looks like this for UNCG on the mound. Of course, Matt Frisby behind the plate. Ryan Clinch, third base, Michael Goss. Second base, Austin Embler. Shortstop, Tripp Shelton. And third baseman, Caleb Webster. Outfield from left to right, Cesar Trejo in left, Andrew Moritz in center, and Ryan Sigmund at the right field position. This is a little bit of uncertain terms here for Matt Frisby. He's just allowed two walks on the season, so that's his third walk of the year and four starts. So he's really stingy with the pitches. Just not finding his location as of yet.
For the Tigers, the first baseman, number 10, Zach Belski.
Of course, a lot of basketball going on today. We'll keep you guys updated on that. Of course, UNCG will be headed to the NIT after winning the SoCon regular season championship, advancing all the way to the SoCon final on Monday this week. They'll find out their fate shortly after the NCAA tournament teams are selected. That selection show will be at 8:30 on ESPNU. That'll be a swing and a miss for Belesky. Princeton, their men's basketball team's in action today as well. The first time the Ivy League has had a tournament to determine their champion. Normally it goes to the regular season title holder, which this year would be the Princeton Tigers. As that one's going to be right first base side. Goss goes 6-1, nearly caps it off, but they'll get one on the play. They'll get the lead runner. Excuse me, not the lead runner. We'll get the middle runner in that situation. So that will bring up Nick Hernandez.
Nick Hernandez
on the year, 174 batting average, 4-for-23, one double. That's his only extra base hit. He has scored two runs, though. No RBI on the season. As you'll see here, Goss spins, turns to second, and just a little too hard to handle there for Frisby. He probably could have gotten that one. And that was going to be a liner into right. Sigmund diving to get there. Doesn't get there. And that's going to be the second earned run for Matt Frisby on the year. And little known fact of the day coming at you. So there is a rule. It's pretty much the rule, but it's not always the rule that you can't assume an error. You can't assume a double play. So you can't give an error on a double play. In that situation, you can. It's just so, so tough. And I think that would have been a tough one on Frisby. But the way it's ruled is if it's a throw over to first and they drop the out, you can give an error on it. But that one's probably too tough for Frisby. But if you want to win a lot of trivia games at home, and somebody says you can't call an error on a double play, you pull that one out of your book and you show them. And you win a lot of arguments that way. That's what I'm in the business of, winning arguments. Right, Dan Walker? You just always win them. I didn't know that one either. Actually, I learned that one last year. That one's going to be fouled off and out of play. A comrade of mine at Christian Brothers University, which is in Memphis, Tennessee. Big-time scorer. He actually is the official scorer of the Memphis Redbirds, so he knows everything about baseball. He taught that one to me. It kind of blew my mind at first because you always hear you can't assume a double play. You can't assume a double play. There's never an error on a double play. And he's like, well, there is. So just when you thought you know everything about baseball, you're humbled once again. That's going to be a swing and a miss, strike two. or strike three. So he will strike out on that one, and that's probably my worst strikeout call I've ever had.
The third baseman,
helps if you know the count. Well, we're trying to get you updated on a bunch of different things, so no harm, no foul. Let's see. Princeton was locked in a tight one earlier today in their conference tournament. They ended up winning in the Palestra on the home court of the University of Pennsylvania, 72-64 in overtime. So they'll play in the Ivy League championship. That pitch will be low and inside for ball one. They'll play the winner of Yale versus Harvard. That game on ESPNU at 4:15. The championship game for the Ivy League is set for 2 p.m. Eastern time. And that one will tip off, doesn't say what channel on ESPN. But we'll get you that in just a moment. We'll have plenty of time, right, Dan? We got 9 innings of this thing. Dan, of course, will join us on the broadcast eventually, we think. He says yes. He gives me the double thumbs up, shaking thumbs up. So that's good. So not only is he assuring that he's going to be on, but he's saying he had his 5-hour energy drink earlier today. Popped up, drifting back into shallow right center field as Embler, but calling him off as Sigmund, and that will do it. But not after Princeton scores the second run of the year off of Matt Frisbee to take a 1-0 lead into the bottom of the first. You're watching the SoCon Digital Network.
Hi, I'm Barbara Corcoran. To sell your home on time for the most money, you need a sharp agent with a marketing strategy that creates the most demand. Bottom line, you need a partner willing to put their own money on the line for you. In Greensboro and Winston-Salem, it would be Jason Bramblett. He attracts hundreds of buyers and creates so much demand that Jason can guarantee if your home doesn't sell at a price and deadline you agree to, he will buy it. Partner with the agent I trust. Go online or call and get your home sold.
Human beings can be hungry anytime they please. Maybe you messed up and didn't eat enough lunch. Perhaps dinner is very far away. It doesn't matter. Come to Arby's and solve your hunger problems with dollar sliders, cookies, small size fries, drinks, and shakes, each for a dollar from 2 to 5. P.M., not A.M. Arby's, we have the meat.
And welcome back to UNCG as the Spartans get set to take the batter's box for the first time today. And we have an answer for you on the Ivy League championship game tomorrow at noon. It will be on ESPN2, and it will feature the Princeton Tigers versus either Yale or Harvard to determine the first tournament automatic bid in the history of the Ivy League.
Catching for the Tigers, number 6, Max West. On the mound, number 43, Ben Gross.
Leading things off will be Austin Embler, the second baseman for UNCG. Trip Shelton will bat second and play shortstop. Morris, the center fielder, will bat third. Left fielder Cesar Trejo will bat cleanup. Third baseman will bat fifth, Caleb Webster. Batting sixth and playing first base, Michael Goss. Batting seventh and designated hitter, Trey Jacobs. Batting eighth and playing right field, Ryan Sigmund. And rounding out the lineup and catching today is Ryan Clinch. We talked about it a little bit earlier. Ben Gross will be starting this game for Princeton, as that one's going to be looped into left, but underneath of it is Davis for out number one of the bottom of the first. We talked about it earlier, but Ben Gross actually hasn't allowed an earned run on the year. He has eight Ks, and 2 walks and 5 innings pitched. So a little bit of stuff there for the Princeton hurler. That'll bring up Trip Shelton. Trip Shelton, honest. Obviously one of the upperclassmen on this roster. As that pitch will be in there for strike one. Shelton, one of the juniors in the lineup today. Just 2 today. It'll be him and the 9-hole hitter, Ryan Clinch. That one's going to be lined out of play down that right field line. Shelton will dig in once again, and that pitch will be outside. So 1-2 the count here to Shelton. The 1-2 fouled off and out of play. So keep Shelton's hopes alive. See if we can get some interesting facts on this Princeton Tigers team. The Ivy League, obviously, one of the largest athletic conferences in the United States, not necessarily in terms of teams, but in terms of just the sheer number of sports. If you go on Princeton's website, there is an uncanny amount of teams. That one's going to be roped down the right field line. Shelton rounding first and headed for second. It'll get past the right fielder. Shelton's going to go to third, and he's going to slide in safe for what I would assume would probably be a double and then an error on the right fielder. So Nick Hernandez will be called for an error. He kind of overran that one in right field and allowed Shelton to get to third. So good play there, and we'll watch the replay here as it just gets down that line. You'll see Hernandez range over, slide for it. I just don't know what he was thinking there. Because even if you slide and get there cleanly with your bare hand, there's no way you're going to corral that safely. He just tried to make too much of a play there and maybe prevent the triple. But I feel like if he just would have squared it up and ran to the backstop, just made the clean play, he probably had a shot to at least hold it to a double. Tough play, though. Especially a tough break for Princeton. That one's going to be fouled out of play. But back to my point, the Ivy League has some of the most sports you'll ever see. Like, if you go to Princeton's website right now, they sponsor fencing. They sponsor rowing, heavyweight and lightweight, because one rowing wasn't enough. They sponsor squash, water polo, swimming and diving, wrestling. I mean, everything they have, you pretty much can name. They have, as that one's going to be a swing and a miss. Strike three for Andrew Moritz. So two down here with Cesar Trejo coming to the plate. Trejo, of course, hit a home run on Friday, the first game in the series. He just guessed way high on that one. Moritz, the ball just did not drop into the strike zone. Stayed high the whole way. Got Moritz to guess a little bit. Bring up Trejo. First pitch he sees outside corner, strike one. Ben Gross, actually from Cranberry, New Jersey, which, if you're familiar with the area, really close to Princeton, as he went to high school at Princeton High School. So really didn't waver much. I wonder if their colors are the same. That way you get a graduation cake and we're going to college cake that's the same colors. You can knock two birds out with one stone. You don't have to have two different color cakes. Save you a little coin. That pitch will be outside for ball one. So 1-2 the count. And Gross doing a really good job of working ahead. And actually, Gross did not play a whole lot, it looks like, until this season. As that pitch will be a swing and a miss. Strike three, and that will end the inning. So Tripp Shelton gets aboard with a double, advances to third on error, but is left stranded with one out. We're headed to the top of the second. Princeton leads this one 1-0. You're watching UNCG Baseball on the SoCon Digital Network. Left on base. Fast join Natty
Green's Brewing Company in supporting Greensboro. The road to Omaha begins in Greenville, South Carolina. The Southern Conference Baseball Tournament comes to Fluor Field May 23rd through 28th. Enjoy some great college baseball with a trip to the NCAAs on the line in a city the New York Times calls one of the top places to go in 2017. Get your tickets to the tournament and book your rooms in that Greenville today. Experience the games. Explore the city.
These are the student athletes. This is where they train. These are their homes. This is where they become Rhodes Scholars and Academic All-Americans. These are the athletes they've always admired. This is where champions are crowned and moments are made. This is the Southern Conference.
Welcome back to UNCG Baseball Stadium as Matt Frisbee set to take the mound for his second inning of work. Coming into the day with a .43 ERA. And even after his run that he allowed in the first inning, it's only gone up to a .82 ERA. So not too bad, I would assume. I think that gets you a couple wins when your ERA is below one. You don't normally lose
leading off for the Tigers
when you just allow one run a game.
Cody Phillips.
You especially don't lose when you allow less than a run per game. Leading things off for Princeton here in this top of the second frame will be Cody Phillips. Phillips a .143 average. When he leads things off, it bumps up a little bit higher to .333. Frisbee will settle. The right-hander will release and plunk him. And that will be his third hit batter of the year, and it doesn't seem like Frisbee has the location he normally has. Maybe the weather, it's sometimes hard to grip the baseball in the cold.
Max West.
So that might do it, but we'll see. We'll see how he settles in. The first time he's really faced a whole lot of trouble this season was against Michigan State, and he kind of worked around that one. It took a little while, but he got it figured out. And he just missed the target completely there, as he did again to go behind 1-0 to Max West, the catcher for Princeton. That'll be a swing and a miss. Strike one. Max West, a sophomore. Here you go. You don't see this too often. He's a sophomore, and his hometown is Singapore. Only in the Ivy Leagues do you see something like that. He went to Singapore American High School. And while at Singapore American High School, he lettered in baseball and basketball. He was a senior captain of his team. Throw over once again from Frisbee. He was the Southeast Asia baseball and softball tournament champions at his high school, and his team was runner-up in 2011 and 2012. This guy might be my favorite person on the team for Princeton. His full name is Maximilian Alasdair West. And his birthday just so happens to be on Earth Day. What a great day. Honestly, Earth Day 1994, which, does anybody know what Earth Day is? There's a fun fact, Dan. Do you know when Earth Day is? Oh, close but no cigar. Dan says April 23rd. It's actually April 22nd. So just a little bit over. Goodness, this guy has a lot of great facts. Before attending Princeton, he served 2.5 years as a combat diver and a naval officer in the Republic of Singapore Navy. So not only is he smart, he's battle-tested as well. And as that one's going to be down the third base line and fair, that should be extra bases. Rounding third and headed for home will be Phillips, and he'll score easily on a no-out double from Max West. And now we're seeing a lot of trouble here for Matt Frisbee. He just clearly does not have it today.
The shortstop, number 15, Asher Lee Tyson.
Just left it on the outside edge, and West was able to get around it and round it over that third base line. And that'll bring up Asher Lee Tyson. Now that's a name that could be a country music star, I tell you what. Asher Lee Tyson. That pitch will be in there for strike one. So 0-1 here to Lee Tyson. Frisbee with the pitch. Just down the first base line. Goss stabs at it, unable to get there, and that's going to be close. I think that's got to be a hit. So a hit there for Asher Lee Tyson. Puts runners on at the corners as Wes is able to advance on the play.
The left fielder, number 8, Chris
clearly does
Davis.
Not have his stuff going for him, does Frisbee today. This is where you find out how good of a pitcher you are, though, because when you don't have your stuff, you got to find other ways to beat and out power hitters. Frisbee's got to find some of that stuff today. No outs, runners at the corners for the Tigers. Looking to take the lead back in the series. They won the first game. UNCG leveled the series at one apiece with a win earlier today. A series finale, of course, on Sunday. That first pitch coming at 1 p.m. We'll have all the coverage for you on the SoCon Digital Network via our YouTube channel. The pitch from Frisbee. Low. Ball two. It's a 2-0 count here. No away. To Chris Davis, the left fielder. The pitch will be down the first base side and through for an RBI single for Davis. And standing up at first base will be Lee Tyson, and scoring will be Max West. So 3-0 real quick for the Tigers. This is something that UNCG has not seen all season.
The center fielder, number 7. Danny Bear.
To be quite honest with you, Frisbee's struggling against one of the teams that, I mean, outside of the year, you'd think maybe he'd struggle with South Carolina or Michigan State. He really didn't struggle with those teams, but really, Princeton got him figured out. 3-0 Tigers lead with Danny Bear up to the plate, the center fielder for the Tigers. Couple big college basketball games taking place today. Obviously, Duke versus Notre Dame for the ACC championship. Of course, the ACC is king in this region of the world. It'll be a swing and a miss, strike two, especially during this time of year when it seems like every team in that league is in the top 25 heading into the tournament. Pitch from Frisbee just low for ball one. A couple of scores to pass around. SMU, number 12, SMU leads UCF 50-38 in the AAC semifinals. Wisconsin, to Dan's pleasure, up 38-21 over Northwestern, who is likely to go dancing for the first time in their history. Just one of, I believe, a handful of schools to not go dancing since the inception of the NCAA tournament. We'll get you that in a second. That's a good trivia question as well. Kentucky over Alabama today in the SEC semifinal, 79-74. And then the rest are set to come up today as it's going to be a swing and a miss, strike three. And Bayer will go down swinging.
The first baseman, we'll bring up number 10, Zach Belsky.
Zach Belsky, who is 0-for-1 in the second game today, has a chance to improve upon that here. Matt Frisbee obviously would not appreciate if he did. A couple other notable scores. We'll get you on those down the road. We'll keep you updated, obviously. Frisbee with the pitch, swing and a miss, strike one. Come on, Frisbee will settle the pitch in there for strike two. So an 0-2 count here to Zach Belsky. And nearly strikes him out. So there are five teams never to make the NCAA tournament since the inception of the tournament in 1939. Can you name them, Dan? Five teams. One of them plays in the SoCon, actually. As that pitch will be in there for strike three, but the runner will advance on a stolen base over to second base. So Davis will advance on the strikeout via stolen base.
The right fielder,
two away here with runners on at second and third. VMI has actually, I don't know if they've been in there long enough, but they are not on this list. So they would have had to have a team in 1939 and still have never made it. William & Mary's on the list. Army is on the list. He's looking at the screen. This is not fun game when you're guessing off of the screen. And that will bring in two runs as that single up the middle makes it 5-0 in favor of the Tigers from Nick Hernandez. That's what you want your cleanup hitter to do. He had no RBIs coming into the series. Now he's got two. And they came in a big spot with two away to make it 5-0 in favor of the Tigers. It's just a good piece of hitting here, so you'll see in just a moment. Just drives it right up where it came from into center field, and that'll do the damage, especially when runners on at second and third. Two outs, you got to run on the pitch. And they do, scoring two runs. So 5-0. As that pitch will be fouled off and out of play. And you got to think, at some point, there's going to be action in the UNCG bullpen early today. And unfortunately for the Spartans, they're playing a four-game series this weekend. Wance has pitched twice this week already, once in midweek and last night. He might be tired. He's your long middle relief guy. You got to find out who you're going to go to. That one's going to be through the left side underneath Webster's glove and put runners on at first and second off of a Connor Nolan single with two outs. So if you're Link Jarrett right now, you're going to find out quickly who you can trust in these middle relief options, because more likely than not, Wance is not available for a lot of work. He could be available for a little work, but you're going to need a lot more than a little work today. So two outs here, runner on at first and second here in the top of the second. Tigers lead at 5-0. The pitch high. The other teams not to make the NCAA tournament since the inception of the tournament in 1939. William & Mary, Army, the Citadel, and St. Francis, New York. That pitch will be low for ball two. So a 2-0 count here to Flynn. Flynn sees a pitch, swings it up the left side. Webster underneath of it, he'll make the easy out at third. And we're headed to the bottom of the second, but not after Princeton scores four more runs. They lead it 5-0 after 1.5. You're watching UNCG Baseball on the SoCon Digital Network.
In the second inning for the Tigers, they score four runs.
Add big flavor to your next get-together with Subway Catering, featuring good-to-go boxed meals with a side and freshly baked cookie, crowd-pleasing giant subs, and piled-high sandwich platters overflowing with flavorific choices. All made the way you say with everything you love, like jalapenos and chipotle Southwest sauce. Subway Catering is simple and satisfying, a great value for any budget. Just call 877-360 Cater or visit Subway.com and let us take care of any occasion. Subway, cater fresh.
Some of the changes I've seen myself since I've been here at UNCG is just, I've been really challenged. I've been really encouraged to come out of my comfort zone.
As a professor, what I feel is most important is to find that passion.
you have this dream of doing something bigger for the world, but you don't know how to get there, this is the place where you go to figure it out.
Hey, welcome back to UNCG Baseball Stadium. As it's been a rough one so far, UNC is going to need to use their bats more than they normally do when Matt Frisbee's on the mound. They trail it 5-0 after two. Princeton's really been just spraying it all over the field. It really hasn't been a command issue in terms of hitting batters and walking batters. He's only done that twice, one of each. Seven hits for the Tigers through just two innings of work. And if you break that down, Frisbee on the year has allowed just 10 hits all year coming in today in three starts. So he's on pace to, if these Princeton hitters can stay on time, he's on pace to exceed the amount of hits he's given up all year in just probably three or four innings. That brings up Webster here to really get this offense jump-started here in the second, as that'll be the first strike he sees, as it's a 2-1 count. Or 1-2, so it's a two-strike count. The pitch outside, ball two. You saw Webster kind of leading that one all the way in to make sure it crossed the plane out of the zone. The pitch, grounded and popped foul. Webster's really kind of settled into his own here at the third base spot. JoJo Underwood kind of started the year in that position, and Webster came in as a shortstop as a freshman. He knew he was probably going to unseat Tripp Shelton. That one's popped out of play. And he just kind of settled in and found a spot in a natural home at third base. So a 2-2 count here to Webster. The pitch popped foul and out of play to stay even at two. Webster's kind of really done a great job kind of quietly working his way into the lineup and becoming one of the better hitters on the team, at least average-wise, at a 435 clip. As that one's going to be into right center, and making the catch on the warning track is Hernandez for out number one. Good pop on the bat there from Webster, maybe about 5 or so feet from being gone. Got a hold of most of it. Maybe in warmer weather, that one's probably gone, but not today. It's cold. So it 5-0 ball game here for UNCG. They trail this one. That pitch will be outside for strike one. So 0-1 count here to Michael Goss. That'll buckle the knees for strike two. On deck for the Spartans is Trey Jacobs, used in a DH role today. Had a big pinch hit at bat in the first game to kind of get a run. I believe it loaded the bases, actually, for the Spartans, and they later went on to score, I believe, 4 runs in that inning or 3 runs in that inning to go up 5-1. Or 6-1.
It was 4-1 at that time.
It was 4-1 at that time.
Dan Walker jumping on here. They got a couple other things taken care of. Yeah, we scored 2 runs in that inning when Trey came in and had the pinch hit single.
And that's going to be a swing and a miss, strike three for Michael Goss. And just to make sure our people in our truck know that I'm not talking to myself, Dan Walker has joined the crew. So in case he is muted, unmute him. Thank you.
Those frequent listeners are the UNCG Baseball. If you thought Scott was being a little goofy Tuesday night against Elon, it wasn't all on him. He I was supposed to be on. I thought I was on anyway. So I was talking to him. We heard each other in our headsets, but apparently the truck just thought Scott was being crazy and talking to himself. So that's why you never heard me chime in with anything, because they assumed Scott was just talking to himself.
And Dan made some great points. That's the thing the viewers listened out on, or missed out on, the fact that Dan actually has really intelligent points, and they just missed them all. As that pitch will be low, but catches the strike zone for strike one. 1-1, the count, two away. Or 2-1. 2-1 the count. This pitcher will rear back, hurl it, and that's going to be fouled almost out of play, but drifting over and making the catch is the third baseman, Joe Flynn. And that will end the inning. UNCG goes down quietly once again. They trail this one 5-0, headed to the top of the third. You're listening to UNCG Baseball on the SoCon Digital Network.
The road to Omaha begins in Greenville, South Carolina. The Southern Conference Baseball Tournament comes to Fluor Field May 23rd through 28th. Enjoy some great college baseball with a trip to the NCAAs on the line in a city the New York Times calls one of the top places to go in 2017. Get your tickets to the tournament and book your rooms in, yeah, that Greenville today. Experience the games. Explore the city.
These are the student athletes. This is where they train. These are their homes. This is where they become Rhodes Scholars and academic All-Americans. These are the athletes they've always admired. This is where champions are crowned and moments are made. This is the Southern Conference.
And welcome back to the UNCG Baseball Stadium as the Tigers of Princeton lead this one 5-0 after a one-run first and a four-run second inning against the UNCG ace, Matt Frisbee. Frisbee coming into today, only issued 10 hits. Today, 7. As digging in to face the right-handed option will be Cody Phillips. He was hit by a pitch and came across the score in that four-run second. First pitch he sees will be right up the middle. Shelton ranges over, and he boots that one. That's going to be his third error of the day. My goodness, it's a tough, tough day for Tripp Shelton. Normally a slick fielding infielder, and some days you just don't have it. And today is one of those days for Shelton. That'll bring up Maximilian West, a.k.a. Max. But, man, if I had a name Maximilian, I'd be so cool. As Frisbee will settle, the pitch outside in the dirt, ball one. Frisbee once again looking to work behind in the count, 1-0. Max West had a big hit an inning ago. As that pitch will be outside for ball two. He had a double down the left field line, brought in one run in that second frame. And he's got a chance to advance a runner or score a runner on a double here, depending on how swift that runner is. But that pitch will be in there for strike one. So 2-1 count near to Max West. Frisbee settles again, nods, throws over to first. Back in time is the runner. And that pitch will be a chopper, shortstop side. Shelton, 6-4-3, and that'll make up for the error. In one play there from Tripp Shelton. Good scoop and good turn from Embler. to get two quick ones.
It's not an easy double play for Shelton either there. He's ranging over to the third base side, have to deliver a strike from 45, 50 feet away, and Embler with a quick turn able to get the second out at first base.
Yeah, there's no doubt about it. That takes two to kind of work in sync, and it really was well put together there from Shelton to Embler over to first. A good scoop there from Goss as well.
Is that a Ace of Base song? It takes two. Is that who it is?
That's somebody. I don't know who it is, but it's definitely somebody. And that'll be the final out there by Ryan Sigmund. UNCG gets its first really quick inning of the day, and we're headed to the bottom of the third with Princeton leading this one 5-0. You're watching UNCG Baseball on the SoCon Digital Network.
Fans, as a reminder, please be on the lookout for foul balls during today's game. And please return all balls to the marketing table. Check that to the press box.
Hi, I'm Barbara Corcoran. To sell your home on time for the most money, you need a sharp agent with a marketing strategy that creates the most demand. Bottom line, you need a partner willing to put their own money on the line for you. In Greensboro and Winston-Salem, it would be Jason Bramblett. He attracts hundreds of buyers and creates so much demand that Jason can guarantee if your home doesn't sell at a price and deadline you agree to, he will buy it. Partner with the agent I trust. Go online or call and get your home sold.
Human beings can be hungry anytime they please. Maybe you messed up and didn't eat enough lunch. Perhaps dinner is very far away. It doesn't matter. Come to Arby's and solve your hunger problems with dollar sliders, cookies, small size fries, drinks, and shakes, each for a dollar from 2 to 5. P.M., not A.M. Arby's, we have the meat.
The right fielder, number 12, Ryan Sigmund.
And welcome back to the UNCG Baseball Stadium as Ryan Sigmund digs in. He made the final out of the top half of the third. It's only fitting to step into the box for the first half of the bottom of the third. And the first pitch he sees will be jetted into right center field and a diving catch. What a play out in center field from Bear.
That's a heck of a play out there by Bear, able to lay out, get full extension, and rob Sigmund of a couple bases.
Yeah, we've seen a couple web gems here this weekend. You talk about Andrew Moritz. Ryan Sigmund made another play here in the first game. That very well could be on SC Top 10, but goodness, a lot of defense being played. Not a lot of offense and moments, but defense, we've certainly seen a good bit. Wow, what a play there, laying out completely as that one's going to be down the left field line and fair. Rounding first and headed for second is Ryan Clinch, and he will stop there, heavy round, but steps back to second for a one-out double down that left field line. I'll bring up the second baseman, Austin Embler.
Number 8, Austin Embler.
And Dan, this is a guy, Austin Embler, who didn't really play much a season ago, but really kind of jetted into that lineup and has really been probably one of the better hitters all year long for the Spartans team.
Yeah, he's been very consistent so far. Last year he missed some time, so he earned a red shirt. He's played in about 25 games as a freshman 2 years ago, and I know he had a big fall. I was talking to, we had our video shoot the other day, a couple weeks ago now. I was talking to Jake Cush beforehand, and Cush was telling me about how good Embler was supposed to be, and in the fall he hit for, I don't know, 400, 500 average. So heard, if you got the recommendation from Jake Cush, I was feeling pretty confident about him.
Yeah, I mean, it's hard to keep a guy out of the lineup if he hits 430 in fall and hits all your pitchers. You might as well say, my pitchers are worth anything. I got to put this guy in the lineup too. And it's definitely paid off for Link Jarrett's bunch. And it goes to show how much as that pitch misses outside. It goes to show how much baseball has kind of changed, because normally your middle infielders weren't going to hit for a lot of power, weren't going to really do a whole lot for you average-wise. But now it seems like middle infielders are developing a lot of pop. You're seeing a lot more pop from your second and shortstop. That's exactly what Austin Embler's kind of provided this lineup.
Yeah, he's been a very consistent hitter throughout the first 13, 14 games of the season. Obviously, his average shows that, and he's not just an average guy, but he's driven in 10 runs so far this season, scored 7. Threat on the bases, too, with 2 stolen bases.
And 3 extra base hits early in the season. All those doubles, obviously. Once it gets warmer, though, you'll see a lot of those doubles turn into home runs. It's just crazy how cold it is. You can't really hit the ball as far as you want, maybe when it's 75 and sunny or 85.
Right.
As that pitch will miss and will walk runners to first and second now. As Clinch is over there, obviously, because of his double just a moment ago.
His shortstop, number 2, Tripp Shelton.
I'll bring up Tripp Shelton, another guy in the middle of that infield that provides a little bit of pop for this UNCG team. 348 average on the year. 16 hits and 46 tries. 3 doubles, just the same amount as Imler on at first base. And that one's going to be up the shortstop side. Lee Tyson will boot that play and load the bases. It's got to be an error.
Yep, that'll be an error on Tripp's counterpart there out of shortstop for Princeton.
The center fielder,
Lee Tyson,
4.
I missed the play looking down to call out the right name. All of a sudden, I see the ball booted past the second baseman. Let's see a replay here. So he just kind of ranges over and just hits off of his chest, and that's not what you want to see if you're the starting pitcher. As that one's going to be into left field, should be deep enough to tag and score Clinch for UNCG's first run of the nightcap game. So that error does come back to haunt Princeton, as that obviously would not have scored if there were 2 outs on the board, as that would have been the 3rd and final out of the inning.
The left fielder, number 24, Cesar Trejo.
I'll bring up Cesar Trejo. Trejo struck out in the first inning. As he will step out, call for time. Runners on at first and second for Trejo. First pitch he sees in there for strike 1. Gross with the pitch outside. Ball 1. So 1-1 the count here to Trejo. Trejo, obviously a native of Guilford County. Local product here for this UNCG Spartans team. That'll be looped foul and out of play. Not a lot of people braving the weather today, but we do have a good bit of faithful out in their blankets and coats and scarves. This has not been the typical day here in Greensboro. It's been rather mild winter, and all of a sudden now, as the back half of winter is coming to an end, it's getting all of a sudden cold again. And for a swing and a miss, strike 3, and that will end the inning. Trejo got us down on strikes. And UNCG will come back to the field for the top of the 4th inning. You're watching UNCG Baseball on the SoCon Digital Network.
Add big flavor to your next get-together with Subway Catering, featuring good-to-go boxed meals with a side and freshly baked cookie, crowd-pleasing giant subs, and piled-high sandwich platters overflowing with flavorific choices, all made the way you say with everything you love, like jalapenos and chipotle southwest sauce. Subway Catering is simple and satisfying, a great value for any budget. Just call 877-360-CATER or visit subway.com and let us take care of any occasion. Subway, cater for.
Some of the changes I've seen myself since I've been here at UNCG is just, I've been really challenged. I've been really encouraged to come out of my comfort zone.
As a professor, what I feel is most important is to find that passion. Do you have this dream of doing something bigger for the world, but you don't know how to get there? This is the place where you go to figure it out.
Well, Welcome back to UNCG Baseball Stadium. We're going to get the score from another sport that's going on in today's action just across the street over at softball. UNCG knocked off Winthrop 4-3 in that game. Alicia Bozonski picked up the win in that game. 7 innings pitched, 4 hits, 3 runs, 2 earned, 1 walk, 3 Ks, and did not allow an extra base hit. For UNCG, the offensive leader, Rebecca Kale, 1-for-3, a double, and 1 RBI. Bozonski with the win improves to 8-6 on the year. They will take on Campbell in their final game of their home tournament today at 5 p.m. It's already 5 p.m., though, so I'm sure they probably pushed that back just a little bit. Just like we got pushed back just a little bit, our projected 4 p.m. start time, we started around, I guess, 4:07, somewhere in there.
4:09, first pitch.
4:09, so close.
Which reminds me, I got to change that.
Yet not close enough, as that pitch will be low and in the dirt from Frisbee to start 0-1 to Chris Davis. Not that Chris Davis on the Baltimore Orioles. That pitch will be high for ball two. So 2-0 count here to Davis. Davis, the left-handed hitter. Frisbee pitching inside once again. And he just does not have it today. He's really laboring to find the strike zone. And when he does find the strike zone, he leaves it up. And it's able to be hit. Pitch from Frisbee outside, and that'll be ball four, a four-pitch walk to the leadoff hitter. Just does not have it, and the bullpen is getting a little bit more anxious down that right field line for the Spartans.
The center fielder, number 7, Danny Bear.
I'll bring up Danny Bear. Of course, made that fantastic catch in center field an inning ago. As the action down in the bullpen looks like a 27 for UNCG. That can't be right. Maybe a 37, Bryce Keller, maybe? Oh, looked on the wrong sheet. Jake Mayhew for UNCG. Princeton doesn't have a 27. If you're wondering, if it gets to that point later on in the game, Princeton does not have a 27. Dan looked at me like I had 3 heads.
As 22, Alex Silva warming up for UNCG. Oh,
so not him, and that ball is way gone.
Yep.
See ya. That's a 2-run home run for Danny Bear, and that one is in the parking deck, and all of a sudden, Alex Silva is warming up a little bit more frantically. It's a 7-1 Princeton Tigers lead here at UNCG Baseball Stadium. My goodness. Danny Bear.
There's no doubt about that one.
No doubt at all. He just turned, and the lead runner took a slow trot to second. Didn't even look back.
It's never good when the right fielder, if you can see Sigmund on this one, just took 2 steps and just stopped.
Not even a courtesy trot for his pitcher, unfortunately.
It's a well-struck ball by Danny Bear there.
Goodness. Well, that'll be chopped foul and out of play for Zach Belsky. And Frisbee came into today with an ERA of 0.43. Currently, it's 3-0 now.
Just bringing him a little bit back to reality. Not saying Frisbee isn't as good as the numbers he's put up, but it's just kind of the way baseball goes.
Sometimes it's just not your day. As a flip over to Frisbee for a 3-1 put out for out number one on the top of the fourth.
Now, Matt's a kid who showed glimpses of being able to do what he did the first 3 weeks of the season this year, last year, because
right
he learned SoCon all freshman honors. This year, he's just kind of, or this game at least, he isn't quite as consistent as he has been in the past this season.
Yeah, and you're going to have those, and especially in cold days, sometimes, especially if you rely on the rotation of the baseball, you just can't grip it as well on these cold days. I know Dan probably doesn't think it's cold because he's from Wisconsin, and apparently the cold doesn't exist up there. But it's definitely cold outside, and it's going to affect the pitcher's fingers.
It exists up there. I have a problem with saying it's cold down here.
As that one's going to be just over the second baseman Embler's head into center field for a one-out single. So it's just another one of those days here for Frisbee, and you just got to find ways to get out of it, and he just hasn't been able to work around it. We talk about what makes a good pitcher great, and it's being able to work around a game and get hitters out when you don't have your right stuff, and Frisbee's just not to that point yet. He's only a sophomore. He's got the ability to do something like that. Just not there yet, and that's going back into left field, and Trejo underneath of it. He'll make the catch on the track or just outside of it for out number two. It's definitely not something easy and easily able to do, though.
Joseph Flynn.
Clearly, Frisbee working on it. So 7-1, Tigers lead. Bring up Joseph Flynn. It'll be a swing and a miss. Strike one. But even so, I mean, he's still eating up a little bit of innings for you if you're UNCG. And you have the offense that can score runs and get back into it. And that's something that's really big for Link Jarrett right now, because he needed his right-handed hitter, right-handed arm to eat up innings. And he's done that at least for the time being, as that pitch will be outside for 1-1 count. Frisbee will settle once again. The pitch on its way inside for ball two. Runner on at first, two away. Frisbee looking to get out another inning. That one's going to be popped up into center field. Moritz drifting back. That should do it. And it does. We're headed to the bottom of the fourth. Princeton leads this one 7-1. You're watching UNCG Baseball on the SoCon Digital Network.
Two hits, no errors, one runner left on base. Fans, it's bow time.
The road to Omaha begins in Greenville, South Carolina. The Southern Conference Baseball Tournament comes to Fluor Field May 23rd through 28th. Enjoy some great college baseball with a trip to the NCAAs on the line in a city the New York Times calls one of the top places to go in 2017. Get your tickets to the tournament and book your rooms in that Greenville today. Experience the games. Explore the city.
These are the student athletes. This is where they train. These are their homes. This is where they become Rhodes Scholars and academic All-Americans. These are the athletes they've always admired. This is where champions are crowned and moments are made. This is the Southern Conference.
Welcome back to UNCG Baseball Stadium. Coming to the plate for UNCG is number one, Caleb Webster, to lead things off. And everybody's favorite, this day in history, 1888, a torrential rainstorm hit the East Coast, as this pitch will be outside. The rain turned to snow the next day and became the blizzard of 1888, the most famous snowstorm in American history, as it caused more than 400 deaths. As that pitch will be into left field, drifting back and making the catch on the warning track is the left fielder, Chris Davis, for out number one of the fourth
inning.
First
baseman, number 18, Michael Goss.
And aren't you glad that that snowstorm kind of changed tomorrow?
Yep, we had snow in the forecast for Sunday, prompting softball to cancel. It's our third day of the Spartan Invitational, but we kept ours on, and now the forecast cleared up a little bit and look like we can play a fourth game tomorrow.
And that's always good when you can play baseball, especially baseball against a team that you match up pretty well against. It seems like UNC and Princeton are pretty even, so it's a good test for both these clubs. That one's going to be popped up into shallow right center field, and ranging over and making the catch is Bayer for out number two.
The designated hitter, number 25, Trey Jacobs.
I'll bring up Trey Jacobs, the designated hitter today. redshirt freshman. And that just goes to show what you can do in college baseball. You can take a year off, you can learn a lot of things, and come in and be a real big contributor in your redshirt freshman year. And that just goes to show what kind of mentality Trey Jacobs has to come in and kind of do that in his second season in Greensboro. He's already got three RBIs on the season. He's picked up two hits, three walks, and one of those was a double. The pitch will just catch the corner for strike two. That pitch will be popped up down that left field line and out of play. 0-2 count here to Jacobs. UNCG will continue their homestand for quite some time, it seems like. But it is kind of nearing the end of that homestand as that pitch will be high for ball one. They'll play one more weekend non-conference series at home next weekend, Thursday from the 16th to the 18th versus Lafayette. A four-game swing as that one will be swing and a miss. Strike three, and Jacobs will go down on strikes. We're headed to the bottom of the field. We'll get you more on that updated schedule when we come back.
For the Spartans,
you're watching UNCG Baseball on the SoCon Digital Network.
No runners left on base.
Hi, I'm Barbara Corcoran. To sell your home on time for the most money, you need a sharp agent with a marketing strategy that creates the most demand. Bottom line, you need a partner willing to put their own money on the line for you. In Greensboro and Winston-Salem, it would be Jason Bramblett. He attracts hundreds of buyers and creates so much demand that Jason can guarantee if your home doesn't sell at a price and deadline you agree to, he will buy it. Partner with the agent I trust. Go online or call and get your home sold.
Human beings can be hungry anytime they please. Maybe you messed up and didn't eat enough lunch. Perhaps dinner is very far away. It doesn't matter. Come to Arby's and solve your hunger problems with dollar sliders, cookies, small size fries, drinks, and shakes, each for a dollar from 2 to 5. P.M., not A.M. Arby's, we have the meats.
And welcome back to UNCG Baseball Stadium as Princeton leads this one 7-1. UNCG looking to rally, but they can't do so right now. It's the top of the fifth. You know what that means. Matt Frisbee's back on the hill.
Of course.
Although he doesn't have his best stuff, he's really kind of powered his way through that, Dan. What does that kind of say about a guy like Frisbee and his kind of maturity in year two?
No, it's just showing that he's a guy that we need to, that he's going to be counted on to get a lot of innings. And even when he doesn't have his best stuff, he knows that that's what he's counted on doing. He's got to keep going out there and being consistent and try to find ways to get guys out. Even if he doesn't have, he's not on his A game, he's got to still be able to be a consistent contributor for this Spartan club.
And it's been kind of a weird day for UNCG as Frisbee sets to pitch to Phillips. As it'll be lined out to Embler. It's been a weird day, though. You see Frisbee out there struggling. You see Tripp Shelton out there struggling. Those are guys that you expect to put up big numbers each and every day, but sometimes you forget how special what they're doing is, and you just lose sight of the fact that they still are human. They're still going to make plays, and they're still going to make mistakes, but at the end of the day, they're going to be more often than not better than average.
Right. That's why it's a beautiful thing about baseball. You got 56 games. For at least NCAA, well, UNCG in the NCAA. For Princeton, you only got 40, but that's
And even then, that's knock on wood, because you have these things called weather, whatever
right.
that means.
Right. So it's just, it's a lot of season. It's a lot of games. You're going to be off once or twice. It's got to have the mental toughness to be able to come back in. And like Matt in this case, if he can come back in, dial it in for the couple more innings, two or three, put up a couple zeros, that'll do a lot for his confidence.
That's another thing in this series within the series that's in there for strike two. You want to win each game in the series, but more often than not, you're setting up to win the series. And if UNCG can't come back and win this one, they can still at least tie the series. And that's where Frisbee comes into such a big play right now, is the more innings he can give you today, the more bullpen you can go to tomorrow and use that to your advantage to try to level the series or win the series 3-1 tomorrow afternoon. Pitch from Frisbee outside for ball four. So Max West will walk to first. So one away here, runner on at first base.
The shortstop, that'll bring up Asher Lee Tyson.
Asher Lee Tyson. Frisbee will settle in. The pitch on its way, low, ball one. And kind of what Frisbee's doing here is something that makes one of the Washington Nationals pitchers a very good pitcher, although sometimes it doesn't feel that way. Gio Gonzalez, no matter what, he'll have bad startings. He'll have really bad starts. And somehow you'll look up and you'll see it's still a 6-1 ball game or a 6-2 game, and Gio's still out there. He's given up 6 runs, but he's gotten you to the 6th inning, which saves your bullpen. It's so important to do things like that because it's such a long season, and your relievers, I mean, to get up every single game, it wears on them. As much as you can save them, the better your ball club will be, and that's what makes Gio such a good pitcher. Although he doesn't get the wins, the ERA isn't as great as you want it to be, but he does work long into the games. That's such a huge part of baseball.
Right, like what you're saying, Scott, is it saves the bullpen arms. They're not having to get up in the third inning and having to get through, you know, 6-7 innings on their own, then come back and try to pitch tomorrow too. It's a tall order of your bullpen if you're asking them to do that.
And that's a line out to right field. Sigmund was camped underneath of it, lost it in the lights, it seemed like. And rounding third and headed for home is Max West. And rounding third and stopping there is Lee Tyson. And you can't really score that one as an error, but it pretty much was. It'll go down as a hit. A triple there for Asher Lee Tyson. It's not one thing, it's another for this UNCG ball club in game two. I mean, he was just absolutely camped and just lost it in the sun.
Chris Davis.
Quite fortunately, he's lucky that wasn't an inside the park home run.
Mm-hmm. That's the thing about this field is when the sun starts setting, it's right in the eyes of the right side of the field, the first base, second base, and Sigmund out there and right. And there's a low line drive that just wasn't able to get above or below the sun, I'm assuming anyway, and Sigmund just unable to make a play on it out there and right.
And obviously a position normally patrolled by Ben Spitznagel, of course, out with an injury right now. So maybe not the best spot for Sigmund to be in. And Link Jarrett's going to come out and talk to his pitcher and kind of see how his day is going and make the call to the bullpen. We'll get back to you with the new pitcher after this. It should be Alex Sova. We'll get you all his numbers when we come back. You're watching UNCG Baseball on the SoCon Digital Network.
Big flavor to your next get-together with Subway Catering, featuring good-to-go boxed meals with a side and freshly baked cookie, crowd-pleasing giant subs, and piled-high sandwich platters overflowing with flavorific choices. All made the way you say with everything you love, like jalapenos and chipotle southwest sauce. Subway Catering is simple and satisfying, a great value for any budget. Just call 877-360-CATER or visit subway.com and let us take care of any occasion. Subway, cater fresh.
Some of the changes I've seen myself since I've been here at UNCG is just, I've been really challenged. I've been really encouraged to come out of my comfort zone.
As a professor, what I feel is most important is to find that passion.
Do you have this dream of doing something bigger for the world, but you don't know how to get there?
Alex Sova.
This is the place where you go to figure it out.
New pitcher for UNCG is Alex Sova, 3.6 ERA, 2.0 whip, and with runners on, they're batting 180 against the right-handed option. So far this season, he's pitched 5 innings, giving up 4 hits, 2 runs, 2 of those earned, 5 Ks, 6 walks, and has allowed one long ball. And he's a guy that UNCG has called on time and time again. In these type situations, they've been down or close with another team in these middle innings, and they've gone to him time and time again. Let's see if he can answer the bell, Dan. For Princeton, Chris Davis. These jerseys, I don't know if you noticed it or you point them out, they look very much like the Baltimore Orioles. Get to Princeton yesterday, looked very much like the San Francisco Giants today. Very much Baltimore Orioles, and he's wearing number 8. I would like to think in honor of the Iron Man, Cal Ripken.
You'd like to think so.
But his name is Chris Davis, so maybe he's a big Crush Davis fan. That pitch will be down in the strike zone for strike one. Silva will settle it up once again. That pitch check, did he go?
Yes, he did.
And he did. So 0-2 count here to Davis, and that's a good start if you're Silva. You want to throw a lot of strikes, fill the zone, and he's certainly doing that right now.
Well, that's what we saw. The difference between the first game and this game is Bryce Hensley was consistently starting ahead of hitters and working from ahead and being able to use that breaking ball as a swing and miss pitch. And Matt Frisbee, unfortunately, today was not able to work ahead of hitters and was consistently behind. And that settles in for fastball counts for batters who are better able to pick up on those.
That'll be a called looking strike three for the first out of Sova's appearance. Two down here. Runner on at third base.
The center fielder, number 7, Danny Bear.
Just you see the fastball coming in right at the knees of the hitter. Just not able to get a good look at it before he – or got a good look at it because he didn't swing, I guess.
He got the best look at it, but it was way too late for him to swing. He took too long to look at it.
There it is.
Thought too much. Well, that pitch will be low to Bear. 4-1. Silva will look for the sign once again. A 1-0 count. And he'll step off the mound.
Now, Silva's a guy that's got the big, big body that you're looking for in a reliever to be able to really fire it in there. He's listed at 6'7", 235 pounds.
So what you're saying is he could be a good 3-4 in basketball.
Yeah, something like that.
But he picked baseball.
Picked baseball, yes.
Which, actually, that's becoming more and more common in baseball because you can get so much more strength behind your pitch if you're that much longer.
Exactly, and his stride, breaking ball misses there, 2-1. And his stride can get him that much closer to the plate. So compared to him, if you compare him to Chad Sykes came in through a perfect ninth inning, 9 strikes, 3 strikeouts. Sykes listed about 5'10". I mean, when he takes his step, he's at about, you know, we'll rough it out at 8 feet, we'll say that.
Yeah.
Compared to Silva, when Silva's stretching out, we'll say he's stepping 10 feet. It's probably a little bit much, but hypothetically. So he's releasing the ball at 58 feet compared to Sykes at 60. A little less time.
And that, my friends, is Sports Science by Dan Walker.
That's why it doesn't make any sense.
And that'll be a called looking strike three for Danny Bear. And we're going to the bottom of the fifth inning. UNCG trails this one 8-1. You're watching UNCG Baseball on the SoCon Digital Network.
Hi, I'm Barbara Corcoran. To sell your home on time for the most money, you need a sharp agent with a marketing strategy that creates the most demand. Bottom line, you need a partner willing to put their own money on the line for you. In Greensboro and Winston-Salem, it would be Jason Bramblett. He attracts hundreds of buyers and creates so much demand that Jason can guarantee if your home doesn't sell at a price and deadline you agree to, he will buy it. partner with the agent I trust. Go online or call and get your home sold.
Human beings can be hungry anytime they please. Maybe you messed up and didn't eat enough lunch. Perhaps dinner is very far away. It doesn't matter. Come to Arby's and solve your hunger problems with dollar sliders, cookies, small size fries, drinks, and shakes, each for a dollar from 2 to 5. P.M., not A.M. Arby's, we have the meats.
And welcome back to UNCG Baseball Stadium as we are set to take the field for the bottom of the fifth inning. Princeton leading this one 8-1.
Leading off for the Spartans, the right fielder, number 12, as Ryan,
will be
Sigmund.
Ryan Sigmund to the dish, a senior out of Danville, Virginia, one of the greatest states in this here United States. As that pitch will be in there for strike one.
And Scott's completely unbiased opinion.
Yeah, I mean, Wisconsin, to be honest, was receiving votes in the poll, but they didn't make the cut. As that pitch will be outside for ball one. I will say this: our office down in the dungeon of Fleming is represented by a lot of different states. We got a North Carolina, we got a Pennsylvania, we got an Ohio, we got a California, we got a Massachusetts, we got a Wisconsin, we got a Minnesota, we got a Virginia. Goodness, that's a good start to the states of the United States. We don't have a state represented twice, honestly. So that pitch will be high. Ball two. It's pretty hard to do.
Nothing I can think of, yeah.
Wow. Never sat down and thought about that one. But that's quite impressive.
Matt McAllister doing a good job of getting people from all over the country down here into Greensboro.
It's what you call diversity. As that pitch will be up the middle and off the hand of glove of Gross. And that'll be a base hit. Leadoff single for Ryan Sigmund.
Those are the kind of plays for Sigmund that haven't quite fallen through yet this year. Last year he was a 330, 329 hitter. And you see here he chops it just back up over the pitcher. Shortstop not able to come in on it. Sigmund's last at bat was made good contact with it and drove it into right center. And Danny Bear was able to lay out and make that diving catch on it. This one not nearly as hard hit, and a little chopper able to sneak through for a hit instead.
Isn't it crazy how unfair the game of baseball is sometimes?
It is.
He has a good hit, and then he has a chopper that shouldn't be a hit any day of the week. He just rolls over the pitcher's head, and somehow you're on first. You look at the box score, be like, 1-for-2. That one hit must have been pretty good. Right. No, it was actually the reverse. His one out was really good. His one hit was kind of a fluke. That pitch will be outside for ball one to clinch. I'll tell you what, Clinch has done a really good job this year. He's kind of been pressed into duty, taking the place of Jake Cush as he's battled an injury, but really kind of settled in there for UNCG and provided a lot of good at-bats for Link Jarrett's squad.
Yeah, Clinch has been one of the more consistent hitters throughout the lineup this season, and like you said, his defense has really improved behind the plate as well, recruited as an outfielder and pressed into duty behind the plate, and has really been continuing to work on his craft as he drives that one down the right field line, foul. And really continues to improve his craft behind the plate and blocking pitches and throwing to bases and all that, you know, all the stuff that comes with being a catcher.
So what you're saying is Clinch has been clutch.
Clinch has been clutch.
There we go. We were getting there. I just wanted to set you up for that one. I was like, come on. We got you. And that'll bring up Ryan Clinch, obviously, a 311 hitter on the year and a 353 hitter with runners aboard, which is his situation currently. That's going to be a good bunt, but just foul. So, in saying that was a good bunt that goes foul, I don't think I've ever seen a good bunt that actually went foul, so I am incorrect on that statement. It's not a good bunt because it went foul.
The idea was good.
It was a good. It seemed like it was well placed. It just took a beeline out of play. So a 2-2 count here to clinch. Spartans looking to claw their way back into this one. And he goes back the opposite way he went before, except this time it's a swinging foul. Stay in there, 8-1 ball game in favor of the Ivy League Tigers. And that pitch will be fouled off and out of play to stay at 2-2. Dan, how many Ivy League schools do you apply to coming out of high school?
We're going to go with 12.
You applied to all 12 of them. I think there's only 10, so that's impressive.
And that would be why I didn't get in. You
applied to the two fake ones. I got into those. Down the right field line, and Clinch will be rounding first and headed for third is Ryan Sigmund. So runners on at the corners, no outs here in the bottom of the fifth. And this is what you got to do if you're UNCG. You got to just claw and fight and scratch and stay in this one. Score a run, an inning, and just work your way back into it. If you score a run, as you see the ball just kind of dribble out in the right field, if you score a run each inning the rest of the way, it gets a little bit more interesting. Instead of a seven-run deficit, it turns into a three-run deficit, and you just have to add a pair or two in a different inning.
Exactly, and this Spartan offense is one that can score in bunches or grind it out one at a time. They've done a little bit of both so far this season.
And you talk about UNCG, one of the biggest ways you've seen that this year was their game against Michigan State all the way back on Saturday, February 25th. They did lose that game 22-16, but it seemed like they battled back after each inning. They gave up a big number, and they came up and put runs on the scoreboard. That just shows that your team is always going to fight for your pitchers, and that's exactly what you want. And that's going to be up the middle and scoring Sigmund on an RBI single up the middle from Austin Imbler.
Yeah, like you were saying with that game against Michigan State, UNCG was down by, I'm going to say at least 10 at one point, I think, and then they ended up coming back and scoring seven in an inning, making it a ball game, cutting it to, I think it was 19-16 at that time before Michigan State scored another couple of runs in the top of the eighth or top of the ninth inning, so it's just, it's an attainable goal. It's not something you set out to do, is to try to score seven innings to come back into a game, but it's something this offense is capable of doing.
Yeah, now 8-2, so a little bit even more manageable now, and that just speaks to the attitude and will to win behind Link Jarrett and kind of what he's instilled in this team. I mean, when you leave behind as many records in the record book as Link Jarrett did at a team like Florida State, there's got to be a little bit of competitiveness in you.
Oh, I'm sure there's a little bit. There's a little bit in Link.
Just a little bit. Certainly done a great job here at UNCG. His record just below 500, but the way he's kind of turned this program around and developed a team that each year is going to be in contention for the SoCon title has been quite impressive accomplishment by Jarrett and his coaching staff. Of course, picked to win the SoCon this year between either them or Western Carolina, depending on who you look at.
Mercer's another one that's been in there. They've won the league the last 2 years, and we're picked at least in the top two or three for each of those polls. This is a team you got to look out for.
And one thing to really note about that is college baseball hinges so much on the pitching aspect, and I think we'd all be one to say that maybe not the strongest suit for the Spartans, but that just goes to show how much they respect the hitters for the Spartans team. They know that they're never going to be out of any game, no matter how many runs they're behind or what kind of situation their pitching staff is in. That's just such a credit to what Jarrett and his staff have done for these hitters here at this university.
Yeah, it's definitely been something UNCG has hung its hat on with Coach Jarrett, but with teams in the Southern Conference, you got to have a good offense to be able to play with these teams.
That's a great play by Lee Tyson, spun to second, throw to first in time, and what a double play. I'd like to see that one again. My goodness. A diving stab, flip turn. That's about as textbooks as you can get it on a fantastic play.
Andrew Morris.
Sliding stab, flip to second, throw to first. Doesn't get much better than that. Wow. Flash a little glove, big fella. That one's going to be popped up. That should do it in the inning. Drifting over is the third baseman, Flynn, and he'll make the play. And a dangerous inning averted just like that for the Tigers. We're headed to the top of the sixth. Princeton leads this one 8-2. You're watching UNCG Baseball on the SoCon Digital Network.
In the road to Omaha begins in Greenville, South Carolina. The Southern Conference Baseball Tournament comes to Fluor Field May 23rd through 28th. Enjoy some great college baseball with a trip to the NCAAs on the line in a city the New York Times calls one of the top places to go in 2017. Get your tickets to the tournament and book your rooms in, yeah, that Greenville today. Experience the games. Explore the city.
These are the student athletes. This is where they train. These are their homes. This is where they become Rhodes Scholars and academic All-Americans. These are the athletes they've always admired. This is where champions are crowned and moments are made. This is the Southern Conference.
And welcome back to the UNCG Baseball Stadium as Princeton leads this one 8-2 after five innings of work. After five innings of work, we're in the top of the sixth. And on for his second inning of work, or at least the start of the second, Alex Soba. He pitched the final two innings of last frame. And we just watched the commercial for the SoCon Baseball Championships in Greenville. We're getting there. Dan, you kind of had a chance to take that in last year. What's it like going down to Greenville for fans that want to go for the first time? What's that kind of experience like at Fluor Field? And is it one of the top in college baseball?
It's kind of up there. I mean, it's Greenville Drive, their affiliate, unaffiliate of the Boston Red Sox. And Fluor Field is set up kind of the exact same way as Fenway. The only thing that's missing is that, you know, the 4-foot wall in right field that Fenway has, but they got a normal size wall, 10 feet or whatever there. Left field, they still have the Green Monster. And it's a nice looking facility, that's for sure. It's a great experience. You get some good baseball here down there. So.
Yeah, you definitely do that, and you see a lot of these teams showcase down there in Greenville. And to have it at a minor league park, that's something that not a lot of colleges get to do. I think maybe the Big Ten, they get to have theirs at Target Field every once in a while. And then SEC has theirs at Hoover, which is pretty much like a minor league park. I think they're having theirs in Nashville maybe this year or the next couple of years. But that's really something specific to the SoCon that you really don't get to see everywhere. And such a good venue to have as a host to the end of the college baseball season in the SoCon. Soba looking to prove his worth once again here in the middle innings, an important stretch for UNCG, trying to keep the score low for them, as that one's going to be popped into left field, and underneath of it is Trejo for out number one of the top of the sixth.
The right fielder, Nick Hernandez.
I'll bring up Nick Hernandez, the cleanup guy for this Tigers team today. Hernandez is 3-for-3. He's killing you with singles, though. You know, one RBI single in the first, a two RBI single in the second, and just a plain single in the fourth. This Princeton team's already racked up 10 hits. Now it's going to be popped foul and out of play. Averaging about two per inning. Still plenty of Spartan faithful out here today. So it's going to be a swing and a miss, strike two. For those watching, family and friends and loved ones, I hope their Spartan and Tigers of choice show them extra love today, because it is cold outside, right, Dan?
Yeah, it's a bit chilly.
Not cold, though.
Not cold.
All right. That's going to be a swing and a miss, strike three for Hernandez, and he'll go down swinging for out number two of the frame.
The designated hitter, Connor Nolan.
I'll bring up Connor Nolan. Nolan today. His summary looks like this, as you'll see the strikeout there. He struck out in the first, singled in the second, and flew out to left in the fourth. So 1-4-3 on the day as that pitch will miss outside for ball one. So 1-0 count here to Nolan. Sova rears back and misses low and away. Ball two. Sova seems to have good stuff. He just unable to locate it a lot of the times. And that pitch will be low once again. You'll see 11 pitches from Sova have been strikes, he has thrown 16 pitches, five of which have been for not strikes. And another one there, and that will put a runner on with two outs. And that's where you make it hard on yourself as a reliever with nobody on and two outs. You put a runner on, that's always troublesome.
The third baseman, Joseph.
Obviously much better than leadoff walks. Those kill you. But
right.
You still, when you have a chance to get out of an inning, you want to get out of an inning.
Yeah, ideally you'd like to have the three up, three down clean innings to get through it. And when you issue the two out walkers, kind of that pitch is in there for a called strike. You're just kind of setting yourself up to throw more pitches within the inning, obviously, because you have to get through another batter. So
the other thing in baseball, too, is it's so complex is that not only do you make it harder on yourself, you make it easier on the opponent pitcher, maybe either in the bullpen or warming up as the stolen base sign was on and taking second for the Tigers will be Connor Nolan. But it also keeps the other pitcher, gives them a little bit more rest, gives them a little bit more time to throw warm-up pitches down in the bullpen. So it's kind of a double-edged sword. You hurt yourself and you hurt your offense because they maybe get a little more locked into a pitcher, a little bit more ready-to-go pitcher than what they would have wanted. So that pitch will catch the outside corner for strike two. So it should be two outs and two strikes. So it should be a 1-2 count, two away. So Sova will look over at the runner at second. The pitch popped up. Drifting back and underneath of it is Moritz. He makes the slide over there and makes the final catch of the inning. Right into the bottom half of the sixth. Spartans trail this one 8-2. You're watching UNCG Baseball on the SoCon Digital Network.
Add big flavor to your next get-together with Subway Catering, featuring good-to-go boxed meals with a side and freshly baked cookie, crowd-pleasing giant subs, and piled-high sandwich platters overflowing with flavorific choices. All made the way you say with everything you love, like jalapenos and chipotle southwest sauce. Subway Catering is simple and satisfying, a great value for any budget. Just call 877-360-CATER or visit subway.com and let us take care of any occasion. Subway, cater fresh.
Some of the changes I've seen myself since I've been here at UNCG is just, I've been really challenged. I've been really encouraged to come out of my comfort zone.
As a professor, what I feel is most important is to find that passion.
Do you have this dream of doing something bigger for the world, but you don't know how to get there? This is the place where you go to figure it out.
Welcome back to UNCG Baseball Stadium. We'll get some scores around the country. Going final today in the college basketball ranks. We'll get you some college baseball scores in the seventh inning. VCU knocked off Richmond in the Atlantic 10 tournament 87-77. Arkansas knocked off Vanderbilt in the SEC semifinals 76-62. Yale on top of Harvard in the Ivy League semis 57-53. UConn and Cincinnati just getting started in the AAC semis, 10-9 in favor of the Bearcats. The Big East Championship, it is 7-6 in favor of Creighton over number two Villanova as that pitch will miss outside for ball one. As we mentioned earlier, Kentucky beat Alabama. SMU knocked off UCF 70-59 as that one's fouled out and out of play. Daniels. Wisconsin Badgers knocked off Northwestern 76-48. Vermont knocked off Albany 56-53 in the American East championship, as that'll be shortstop side. Lee Tyson, throw over to first in time, and Trejo will go down on the ground out. Texas State knocked off UT Arlington in the Sun Belt Conference Men's Championship semifinal. That's a upset there, 83-62. NC Central going dancing, 67-59 over Norfolk State. Rhode Island knocked off Davidson, 84-60, as that'll be popped up and out of play. We mentioned earlier, Princeton into the final of the Ivy League. Troy over Georgia State, 74-63 in the Sun Belt semis. Michigan knocked off Minnesota. And of course, Duke and Notre Dame later tonight for the ACC championship. As that pitch will be down Broadway, 4-2 to Webster. So Webster facing an 0-2 count, one away. As that pitch will be through the right side and in for a base hit for Caleb Webster. And Dan, what do you think of freshmen coming into college baseball and having success right away? What do you think is attributed to it?
Well, I think on this pitch, you see how he didn't try to do too much with it. He did a good job of going where it's pitched. And like I said, he's not trying to do too much. Staying within yourself, playing your game, and that'll help you out defensively and offensively. And Webster's really come into his own defensively over at third base, playing a new position, and really turned it on late at the plate.
That one will be popped up into right field, drifting back and underneath of it for out number two of the inning is Nick Hernandez. And I think a lot of it has to do with just when you're a freshman, some freshmen tend to over-amplify everything. And some players just, like you said, just do what they do. And they just have success right away, and they struggle later on because it all catches up to them because the scouting reports come in, and all of a sudden their tendencies come out. But right now there's nothing better you can do as a college baseball freshman than to just play ball. That's what you're brought here to do. Just go out there and do what you do, and you'll be fine.
That's all you can do. Otherwise you're going to spend too much time overthinking it and overanalyzing it and you get in your own head. And that's the worst enemy. Your worst enemy as a baseball player is being in your own head and second-guessing yourself, not trusting your mechanics and your swing and all that kind of stuff.
Exactly right, and that's what Trey Jacobs looking to do here. He misses that one, a check swing that went awry for strike two. So 0-2 count here, two away here in the bottom of the sixth. So back-to-back freshmen in the lineup for UNCG right here. Webster of the true variety, Jacobs of the redshirt variety. The settling pitch, high, ball one. Spartans, like we said earlier, we're going to mention more of their schedule. They'll stay at home for a little bit longer, as Gross will look over at the runner. The pitch, poked out of play, foul. As we mentioned, they'll play Princeton in these four games, and they'll be home to Lafayette the 16th through the 18th. Single game on the 16th, doubleheader 17th, single game on the 18th. They'll host North Carolina A&T at the newly named minor league park of the Hops.
Hoppers.
The Hoppers, excuse me.
As that pitch will be there it is. Sorry.
Swung through and missed for out number three. We're headed to the top of the seventh. We'll get you more of that schedule when we get back. We're watching UNCG Baseball on the SoCon Digital Network.
Hi, I'm Barbara Corcoran. To sell your home on time for the most money, you need a sharp agent with a marketing strategy that creates the most demand. Bottom line? You need a partner willing to put their own money on the line for you. In Greensboro and Winston-Salem, it would be Jason Bramblett. He attracts hundreds of buyers and creates so much demand that Jason can guarantee if your home doesn't sell at a price and deadline you agree to, he will buy it. Partner with the agent I trust. Go online or call and get your home sold.
Human beings can be hungry anytime they please. Maybe you messed up and didn't eat enough lunch. Perhaps dinner is very far away. It doesn't matter. Come to Arby's and solve your hunger problems with dollar sliders, cookies, small size fries, drinks, and shakes, each for a dollar from 2 to 5. P.M., not A.M. Arby's, we have the meats.
back to UNCG Baseball Stadium as we get set to start the top of the seventh inning. UNCG trail this one 8-2 as Alex Sova set to take the mound once again. So back to that home schedule that will continue next Wednesday after that Lafayette series. The 22nd, we'll travel over to the newly named First National Bank Field, home of the Greensboro Grasshoppers, for a 6 p.m. tilt with North Carolina A&T. Then they'll play host to Western Carolina for a three-game set to open up SoCon play the 24th through the 26th. And then they'll round out that homestand with a game against UNC Asheville Tuesday the 28th. First pitch in that one at 6 p.m. And then it's conference play from then on out. They'll be at ETSU, at North Carolina A&T for a midweek game. They'll host Furman at NC State for a midweek game. Then they'll host Wofford. And then they will travel to High Point for a midweek game. And then travel to not just Ohio State. They'll travel to the Ohio State.
Our former colleague C.J. O'Leary would be proud of you for that one, Scotty.
You got to throw it in every once in a while. You got to be grammatically correct for those Buckeye fans.
I don't know how many of them would actually be chiming in, kind of upset with us at this point, but better to be safe than sorry, I guess.
They should all love us, to be honest. There's no reason to not like us. That was going to be grounded up the middle. Sheldon drives in, throw to first in time for out number one. It's gonna be an interesting schedule though, Dan, because you play that first series at South Carolina, and obviously nothing's gonna rattle you more than
the catcher,
that
number six,
in your season.
Max West.
But you play that road trip at South Carolina, that first series of the year, and then you don't play on the road really until at ETSU March 31st. And playing on the road's a whole different bear. You and I both know that it's a lot tougher to win on the road, and it might be a little adjustment period when you go out to ETSU, and that's gotta be really tough for your first road series in conference play to be that much away from your other road conference series or your other road series start the year.
Yeah, it'll be a little different. I mean, it's a big test anyway to play on the road. Sorry, I got distracted by the pitch there.
No, you're funny. You're doing your job. You got distracted doing your job.
No worries. A little tougher to play on the road and say, especially it's the second SoCon series and it's only your second trip away from home. It comes with a little different called strike there. Comes a little different. I don't even know what the right word is.
It's just a little different to play on the road because everything is magnified more in conference play. They mean more. You go out and lose a series on the weekend to a team that you're not, it's not going to come back to hurt you twice. In conference, it hurts you twice because you lose a game in that series and it hurts you in that series, but also hurts you in that conference standing, which can be brutal. Especially when you play so few conference games, it seems like every game counts double. And that'll be ball four to Max West, a five-pitch walk to put a runner aboard at first base.
Well said, Scotty.
The shortstop.
Except for the whole thing, put a board on second base. That would be demonstrative if that happened. You get a walk and they go to second base. That'd be like the international run rule in softball. Mm-hmm. Or tiebreaker, international tiebreaker.
I'm pretty sure they did. We did that in Old Man League softball every now and then.
Dan, you're not old.
Oh, I played Old Man League softball.
That's not fair. You're not old.
What do you call it then? I guess slow pitch softball is the easy way to say it.
You should not be in this league if it's old people. That is unfair.
Anyway. Yeah, if you play co-ed back up in Wisconsin anyway, if you walk one of the women, they get two bases. So you try not to walk.
That's crazy. If I were a woman, I would never swing. I'd be like, you gotta throw me a strike. And you're not allowed to strike out in slow pitch softball, are you?
Yeah, yeah.
Oh, you can?
Yeah,
wow.
It's two strikes, actually. And if you hit a foul on the second strike, you're out.
This is crazy. This is a crazy concept to me right now. This is a 1-0 count to Lee Tyson. That nearly hits him. And taking advantage and headed to second base is Max West. Dan, if your name was Maximilian, would you shorten it? I don't think I would. That's a great name.
It is, but I feel like after a while, it just kind of get hard to say. Not hard to say, but it takes too long. It's three syllables.
That is true.
I mean, this coming from Scott. I mean, short, clear, concise.
Yeah, I only read in 140 characters.
Exactly. Only a
and
Twitter.
And or emojis.
Only a Twitter guy.
Yeah, and or emojis. You got to count those, too. It's a 2-0 count here from Sova to Lee Tyson, starting shortstop for the Tigers. That's going to be in the dirt, not advancing, though, as West. It's a 3-0 count here to Tyson. Sova looking to work around it. We talked a little bit about it earlier, but Sova, as of late, kind of losing a little bit of that control of his command. So far, thrown 30 pitches, 18 strikes, so 12 of which have been four balls. And that one will be another ball. That'll be back-to-back walks for Alex Sova. And just as we say that, another pitcher gets up in the bullpen for the UNCG Spartans. Right now, we've got two.
The left fielder, Chris Davis.
Sova starting his third inning of work. His previous high before this was a two-inning outing against Michigan State, so it's right on the border of where they want him to be at.
And honestly, he's been pretty effective, and we're going to go to the bullpen, it looks like. Luke Jarrett comes out to talk to Sova, and that pitch goes well over the head of the catcher, so maybe he's not ready yet. This might be a little bit more for Sova. As he's just long tossing down there in the bullpen, not sure who it is yet.
It'll be Drew Goodman. Left-handed pitcher. Appeared in three games last year.
Sova will stay in for the time being. Fun fact, Drew Goodman, also the name of the Rockies play-by-play guy. And his home run call is, take a good look, you won't see it for long. That's not a bad one. Maybe we should adopt that one, Dan. As that pitch will be low for ball one.
Wouldn't be the worst idea we've ever had, Scott.
No, we've had a lot of those. The good ideas have been the few ones. That's the problem.
It just makes you appreciate the good ideas that much more, though.
We need more of those good ones. Sova will settle the pitch. Low, ball two. I'd imagine if another walk is issued here by Sova, we will not see him in the game any longer. That's just my guess.
That's a good guess, considering I think he's got six straight balls right now, I believe.
Yeah, and he's walked the previous two batters.
Yeah, it's not an ideal situation if you're a Spartan fan.
I think he walked West on five pitches.
That is correct.
And that will be in there for strike one to Davis. So 2-1 the count here, one away here in the top of the seventh frame. The pitch coming from Sova. Swing and a miss, strike two. So a 2-2 count, and all of a sudden Sova's in a little bit better shape now. Top of the seventh frame. Spartans looking to stay over 500 right now. They're 7-7. Princeton, of course, won their first game yesterday over the Spartans. They're 1-5. The pitch coming. That'll be outside, 3-2, the count. So 3-2 count, one away here in the top of the seventh frame. Runners at first and second. Princeton looking to add to that six-run lead. The pitch on its way in there. Strike three, and that will be a strikeout for Alex Sova. That's a huge way to respond. Link Jarrett comes out, and you can respond one of two ways when that happens. You can panic a little bit, and Sova just kind of settled in.
Danny Bear.
Locked in and got the strikeout after going down 2-0. Dan, let's play one of my favorite games. Let's say, who has the best record in spring training? If you could take a guess.
I'll take a guess.
Which
All
team
right.
is winning the World Series because of their spring training performance?
I'm going to say the best record in spring training right now.
Don't look at my computer screen right now because it's not the best record at the top. I saw you cheating.
That was with your.
You look just looked
tournament.
Over again, Dan. Don't try to play
nonsense.
With me.
I'm going to guess the Yankees anyway.
Darn it, you got it right. 13-3 on the year in spring training as that is low for ball two.
They're running the table.
They are running the table. Got off to a good start. They're 8-2 in their last 10. They've won 4 straight.
Well, to be fair, they were also leading spring training standings on Tuesday when he asked me that question when the truck had me muted.
Oh.
And no one heard my answer.
So you've done well to remember what we talked about. Yeah, did you hear about this, Dan? The Yankees are making their top prospect, Clint Frazier, get a haircut.
I did see that. Yeah, I saw it on a Twitter the other day.
It's one of the most weird, antiquated rules in all of baseball.
Well, it's only with the Yankees that wild pitch skips away from Clinch and runners will move up.
It's always funny to see a player get traded to the Yankees that has, like, long hair or a beard and they have to get it shaved off right as it happens.
Johnny Damon was the best example of that. Back in the mid-2000s.
Oh, he looked like a caveman. And when he goes to the Yankees, he looks super cleaned up. Uh-huh. This is so weird. As the runners advance on a wild pitch there, West to third, Lee Tyson to second.
I guess that's just part of it, being able to put on the pinstripes. I mean, you got to be clean-shaven and haircut nice and tight.
As that pitch will be in the dirt and allow a run to score in West. So Lee Tyson will advance to third on the play, and advancing to first on the walk is Danny Bear. And we're going to make the call to the bullpen. Link Jarrett coming out to visit his pitcher once again. We'll have a new pitcher when we get back. You're watching UNCG Baseball on the SoCon Digital Network.
Together with Subway Catering, featuring good-to-go boxed meals with a side and freshly baked cookie, crowd-pleasing giant subs, and piled-high sandwich platters overflowing with flavorific choices. All made the way you say with everything you love, like jalapenos and chipotle Southwest sauce. Subway Catering is simple and satisfying, a great value for any budget. Just call 877-360-CATER or visit subway.com and let us take care of any occasion. Subway, cater fresh.
Some of the changes I've seen myself since I've been here at UNCG is just, I've been really challenged. I've been really encouraged to come out of my comfort zone.
As a professor, what I feel is most important is to find that passion.
Do you have this dream of doing something bigger for the world, but you don't know how to get there? This is the place where you go to figure it out.
Welcome back to the UNCG Baseball Stadium. A little bit of clarity on that last play. Our official score has gone past ball instead of wild pitch. So I believe that will go down as of right now for Sova. The new pitcher into the game for UNCG making his first appearance is Drew Goodman. Much known about Goodman. As Dan mentioned earlier, made a few appearances, and we got guys sitting down in the outfield. That doesn't happen too often during pitching changes, but I guess Trejo decided it was a good time to take a seat.
Hey, Trejo's new to the outfield. He's not quite sure what's. He saw Moritz taking a knee.
Now he's running around. He's sitting in a nice sprint.
He saw he was on camera, got caught. So I didn't need to run back over to left field.
Yeah, you normally take a knee in the outfield, not a full-fledged seated position.
I told you, he's new to the outfield. He saw Mo take a knee, so he thought he was clear to just take a seat.
Zach Belsky. I'll bring up Zach Belsky. Belsky, a 208 average for the Tigers. And we'll get you, we're looking to get you some baseball scores in around college ball. We'll get you those in the bottom of the seventh. As that pitch will be in the dirt, that should allow a run to score on a wild pitch, but maybe a fantastic play
well
there.
Well done. Attaboy, clinch.
That is about as good as you can get after all, as bad as you can get. A toss from clinch to Goodman to end the inning. And we're headed to the bottom half of the seventh. Goodman doesn't have to do much to get out of that one. Instead, just a wild pitch does it. UNCG trailing this one 9-2. You're watching UNC Baseball on the SoCon Digital Network.
The road to Omaha begins in Greenville, South Carolina. The Southern Conference Baseball Tournament comes to Fluor Field May 23rd through 28th. Enjoy some great college baseball with a trip to the NCAAs on the line in a city the New York Times calls one of the top places to go in 2017. Get your tickets to the tournament and book your rooms in Yab at Greenville today. Experience the games. Explore the city.
These are the student athletes. This is where they train. These are their homes. This is where they become Rhodes Scholars and academic All-Americans. These are the athletes they've always admired. This is where champions are crowned and moments are made. This is the Southern Conference.
And welcome back to UNCG Baseball Stadium, where, as we promised, we're finally getting you some baseball scores from around the country. Liberty lost to St. John's 4-2, number 19 St. John's, of course. Number 21 Coastal Carolina knocked off Illinois 3-2. Number 10 Virginia knocked off North Carolina 2-1. That's 10 versus 13 in that matchup in ACC play. Number 18 East Carolina knocked off Charlotte 10-7. Number 20 NC State beat Wake Forest 8-5. Number 3, Florida State knocked off Boston College 11-1. Number 5, Louisville beat Pittsburgh 8-2. Number 6, Texas Tech upset by UTSA, that's UT San Antonio, 3-2. Number 7, LSU all over Wichita State 12-5. Number 16, Ole Miss 5, Furman 0.
Number 41.
Number 13, North Carolina, 12-2. Bottom of the sixth in the second game of their doubleheader. UL Lafayette up 6-1 over St. Peter's. Number 17, Texas A&M tied with Brown, 2-2 in a ninth inning delay. As we're set back to play, Ryan Sigmund to lead things off. New pitcher in for Princeton. We'll get you that in just 1 second. The new pitcher is number 41, Eli Kimball. Just pitched in one inning this year, giving up one hit, nothing else to his name. So that pitch will be a little bit to the left. Ball two. Number 2, Florida, 2-1 over Seton Hall in the top of the seventh. Number 8, South Carolina, 5-1 over Michigan State. And that pitch will be outside. Number 19, St. John's, 4. Liberty, 6 in game 2 of their doubleheader. A lot of teams moving their games because of impending weather. It's almost like it's going to snow tomorrow or something.
Oh, I think the snow that was supposed to hit us that is into just normal precipitation a little bit south of us. No.
It'll be a four-pitch walk for Sigmund. Coastal Carolina on top of Illinois, 6-0 in their game two doubleheader. Clemson, number 14 Clemson, locked in a 5-5 ball game with Notre Dame in the bottom of the fifth. Number 9, Arizona up 16-2 over Hartford in the bottom of the fifth. Baylor and Houston postponed. Oregon State, number 4, Oregon State up 2-1 on Ball State in the bottom of the fifth. And that'll be in there for strike one. Number 18, East Carolina up 1-0 in game 2 over Charlotte. UC Irvine up 4-0 on number 1 TCU in the bottom of the fourth. And Florida State up 1-0 over Boston College, number 3, Florida State. As that'll be a hit-by-pitch. Ryan Clinch will take his base. And Wake Forest up 1-0 over number 20, NC State, in game 2 of their doubleheader, bottom of the third. Those are the final few of the games in the top 25. Let's see if we get some SoCon scores as UNCG puts runners on first and second.
Austin Embler.
With Austin Embler coming to the dish. Gardner Webb on top of East TSU, 5-1. The Citadel lost to Stetson, 9-2. Wofford knocked off LaSalle, 6-1. VMI knocked off Quinnipiac, 9-5. Mercer on top of Bradley, 6-5. Ole Miss, of course, knocked off Furman, 5-0. Samford and Eastern Illinois postponed. Western Carolina, 8. Nebraska, 2. That's a good score for SoCon. Stetson, 6. The Citadel, 0, bottom of the fourth. And Wofford, Monmouth, 0s, top of the second. And that was mouthful. 1-1 now to Embler as that pitch is called strike down the middle. And you talk about a score being good for UNCG in the conference. That's not necessarily a UNCG score. It's always good to see the teams in your league go out and beat non-conference big-time foes.
Yeah, it always can bump up your RPI for the conference. And obviously having teams on the schedule that have a higher RPI are going to help raise your RPI.
Yep, and especially if you go to a weekend series and knock off Nebraska.
Yeah.
You're not seeing their midweek guy that's a freshman that has potential. You're seeing their bona fide stud on a Saturday. So that's always good for the league, and that'll be strike three looking there for Embler.
The shortstop, number 2, Tripp Shelton.
Gotta bring up Tripp Shelton. Shelton today. He's 1-for-3 to keep his average at 333. He's got a double down the right field line. And he grounded out into a double play, and he reached on an error to the shortstop in the third. Now that pitch will be a little bit low, ball one. Look at the dedication from Spartans fan behind the backstop. They brought their full comforter out to the game. I mean, that's how cold it is outside. But they're still determined to see their favorite Spartans take the field. It'll be in there for strike one. So 1-1 here to Shelton. Shelton, one of the mainstays in this lineup for a few years and another year after this to come. That'll be popped up into center field. Drifting back is Bear, and he'll make the catch. Tacking and going will be Clinch and Sigmund, and easily advancing to second and third, respectively. It's a good heads-up play there by the base runners to advance. It was extremely deep, forcing Bear to go back. We've got a tough play to make on the fly. He had to kind of stop, settle himself, and then throw, which allowed the runners to advance.
Clinch even waiting a half second at first base, make sure the throw was going towards third before he took off for second base as well, was important in that play.
It's good heads-up base running for the Spartans. That pitch will be a little bit low for ball one. That pitch will touch for strike one. And Dan, you've kind of had the tour of SoCon facilities in your first year here at UNC. You obviously haven't seen them all. But in your first year, which would be your favorite road trip as we talk about the Spartans hitting the road for the first time against ETSU late March?
I think I've only got to see about half the stadium. So this year I know the big trip will be down to Mercer because that'll be a tough matchup to begin with. But they just redid basically their press box and they did a lot of work to our field. Not 100% sure how much is done with it, but that'll be a good one to see what they all got going on down there. But I think last year our trip to the Citadel was pretty nice. They play at the minor league park down there with the Charleston
nice.
River Dogs. I think that's what they are, the River Dogs.
That sounds about right.
Okay.
That'll be through the right side, and 2 RBI single for Andrew Moritz. As both Clinch and Sigmund will score.
Moritz extends his hitting streak to 11 games now.
Some people might say that's pretty good.
It's not bad.
He just takes it through that right side hole and drives in two.
Safely reaching base in 54 of 56 career games.
Have you looked that up?
Yeah. Of course I did.
I want to make sure you check your facts, Dan. You can't just come up here with that weak stuff.
No,
I
got to
make sure they're fact checked.
Not expecting the Scott Wyant to be my fact checker here.
This is a bona fide five-star broadcast right here. We have to fact check everything.
And whatever you're not calling me out on, I'm sure our video coordinator, Tony Hermain, is making sure I'm not spouting off any wrong facts.
I'm just hoping he's still awake back there. As that pitch will be popped up from Trejo. That's a high fly ball. Third baseman Flynn underneath of it, and he'll make the snag. And we're going to the top of the eighth, but not after UNCG tacks on two runs to close within five. Princeton leads this one 9-4.
They scored two runs.
You're watching UNCG Baseball on the SoCon Digital Network.
Two runners left on base.
The road to Omaha begins in Greenville, South Carolina. The Southern Conference Baseball Tournament comes to Fluor Field May 23rd through 28th. Enjoy some great college baseball with a trip to the NCAAs on the line in a city the New York Times calls one of the top places to go in 2017. Get your tickets to the tournament and book your rooms in that Greenville today. Experience the games. Explore the city.
These are the student athletes. This is where they train. These are their homes. This is where they become Rhodes Scholars and academic All-Americans. These are the athletes they've always admired. This is where champions are crowned and moments are made. This is the Southern Conference.
Welcome back to the UNCG Baseball Stadium as Princeton leads this one 9-4, headed to the top of the eighth inning, and Drew Goodman on for his second frame of work. As, to be honest with you, his first inning of work was not that hard. His only out he recorded was actually off of a wild pitch. Clinch made a clutch play to tag the runner at home on the wild pitch, thrown over to Goodman, who got the tag down.
Leading off the eighth inning for the Tigers, the first baseman, number 10, Zach Belski.
Zach Belski will lead things off for the Tigers, a 208 hitter. Batting 143 as a leadoff hitter so far this season. Belski obviously got the chance to face Goodman in the inning previous, but didn't get a chance to hit him as that out was applied as he was at the dish. As that pitch will be low for ball one. More action down in the UNCG pen. A little bit of action down in the Princeton pen. Nothing serious, though. Goodman will settle the pitch on its way. Swung on. Strike one. Pitch from Goodman in the dirt. Ball one. Excuse me, ball two, I believe. It's the pitch from Goodman. Swung on and down the right field line. That should be two bases for Belski. Maybe three. But he will be standing up at second with a leadoff double. That'll bring up Nick Hernandez, the cleanup hitter for UNCG. And you just see this kind of just go down that right field line, hugging that line all the way down. And Sigmund doing a good job to get over there, quickly turn and throw home. Or excuse me, throw to second. Goodman will check Runner over at second. Looks in his glove, throws, popped up. In, out of play. And as always, my favorite update of UNCG baseball, which you guys will actually be able to hear today, is asking Daniel L. Wacker, Walker, I was doing so good. That was the first time I messed up today. What is going on in the World Baseball Classic? The folks at home need to know.
Well, Team USA, walk-off winners last night over Colombia.
I'm all in for that.
Oh, yeah.
Go USA.
I think Adam Jones hit the base knock to score one.
There we go. So did they win yet? Did they win it all yet?
No, they played one game.
Oh, so you can't win after playing one game?
No.
Okay. Well, they play the Dominican next.
That'll be a tough matchup.
That game is on March the 11th. Actually,
not
today.
Today
at 6:30 p.m. So
6 minutes.
Yeah, should be coming up.
Roughly.
Yeah, Colombia knocked off Canada earlier today.
Who Joey Votto is not playing for.
He's not a member of.
Right.
But he is a citizen.
He is Canadian.
So he likes Tim Hortons. And if you're a fan of How I Met Your Mother, he probably is afraid
of
the dark.
Afraid of the dark, 100%.
That'll be lined up the middle. That should get down. It does. But Hernandez will only advance the runner to second base as he came to tag up. I don't know how he didn't know that was going to be a single off the bat. That probably should have scored Belsky, but when you're up by five runs, you don't have to force it there.
So he was playing a little safe, and it was kind of a lower line drive, and I'm not sure if it was going to sink fast enough where Shelton was going to be able to make a play on it. So Belsky decided to stick with it a little bit.
So we have a pinch hitter for Princeton. It'll be number 9. I thought he was already in the game.
Pinch hitting.
But he was in the game earlier. He just entered the game now. It's Ramzi Haddad. Haddad, excuse me. Looks like we're going to have a pitching change here as Link Jarrett comes out. That's just my guess. And we will
make the call.
We'll take a quick break. We'll get you the new pitcher in just a moment. You're watching UNC Baseball on the SoCon Digital Network.
Hi, I'm Barbara Corcoran. To sell your home on time for the most money, you need a sharp agent with a marketing strategy that creates the most demand. Bottom line? You need a partner willing to put their own money on the line for you. In Greensboro and Winston-Salem, it would be Jason Bramblett. He attracts hundreds of buyers and creates so much demand that Jason can guarantee if your home doesn't sell at a price and deadline you agree to, he will buy it. Partner with the agent I trust. Go online or call and get your home sold.
Human beings can be hungry anytime they please. Maybe you messed up and didn't eat enough lunch. Perhaps dinner is very far away. It doesn't matter. Come to Arby's and solve your hunger problems with dollar sliders, cookies, small size fries, drinks, and shakes, each for a dollar from 2 to 5. P.M., not A.M. Arby's, we have the meat.
Now pitching for the Spartans from Winston-Salem, number 38, Travis Tuttle.
And welcome back to UNCG Baseball Stadium. It'll be Travis Tuttle. As you see Trejo sitting down once again in the outfield. Very bizarre for me, but maybe that's what you're supposed to do nowadays. And there's Tuttle, a right-handed option for the Spartans out of Winston-Salem, obviously North Carolina. He's a junior, a redshirt junior, that is. He redshirted at App State College. Excuse me, he redshirted at App State before transferring to Surrey Community College. My apologies. As a redshirt freshman, he started 11 games for Surrey Community College, making 3 appearances out of the bullpen. Logged a team high 65 innings, logged 3 complete games, earned a 4.15 ERA, struck out 71 batters, recorded a season high 13 strikeouts in a game versus New River. Also named NJCAA National Pitcher of the Week. They're throwing a no-hitter against number 6, Pasco Hernando State, recording 6 Ks in that one. Suttle looks to make the pitch here, and that'll be fouled off and out of play. Suttle was a member of the Boston Red Sox and Kansas City Royals scout teams in 2012. Fun fact, our very own Daisha Imes' dad coaches those scout teams during the summers.
I did not know that.
That is your fun fact of the day.
That's a very fun fact.
He is a scout in the Kansas City Royals organization. Now that pitch will be lined down the left field line and out of play for strike two. And she was explaining to me the other week when we made our way out to Asheville that her dad coaches those teams, and they play against other teams that are basically built up on scout teams. It's some of the best players in high school ball, and they just kind of want to get an extra look at them. They don't really, I mean, they just play practice a couple times a week, and just a way for the scouts to get an extra look and see if they want to draft that player down the road. Hmm. That pitch will be out of the zone for ball one, 1-2. Tuttle majoring in kinesiology, which, if I'm being quite honest with you, as that play is going to be grounded to the third base side, throw over in time from Webster for out number one, but not before a run scores to make it 10-4, Princeton. See a replay here, and just a smart play by Webster. He probably could have thrown home, thought about it for a second, but you might as well get the sure out. Especially, this is a discrepancy as big as it is. Two outs now on the scoreboard here in the top of the eighth inning. 10-4 Princeton lead. 1-0 count now faces Joseph Flynn. Tuttle looks back in the zone, strike one. So 1-1 the count, two away. One out, incorrect on the scoreboard. So Tuttle will settle, look that runner back at second base. The throw, swing and a miss, overpowering stuff, strike two. So 1-2 count here to Flynn. Flynn wearing number 21. That'll be a swing and a miss, strike three, and that'll be a strikeout to the credit of Travis Tuttle.
The second baseman.
Watch the pitch here. It's just overpowering stuff. And Dan, I'm unfamiliar with the terrain of Wisconsin, especially Wisconsin baseball. We talk about how cold it is here and how tough it is for these hitters to hit. When do you guys start high school baseball in Wisconsin with it being so cold for most of the year?
June. No, I'm kidding. Well, it's normally it's April, May is usually the high school season, and then you play summer ball June, July, into August a little bit.
So how warm does it get in those months when you get into April and May for a high school baseball player?
I mean, I would say this is like a typical day for a spring game for high school ball in Wisconsin.
Oh, that's got to be it's got to be tough.
You're kind of used to it. I mean, you don't realize that 80% of the country is able to play in 60, 70-degree weather six months out of the year.
That's the good life. 1-2 count here to Phillips.
I remember we were playing in a tournament when I was a long time ago, 12 and under baseball, and there was a team from California that flew up to play in this tournament in Wisconsin. And of course,
made the wrong decision.
We got demolished, obviously, because we could only play baseball 3 months out of the year, and come to find out afterwards that this group of, 12, 11 year old kids are playing baseball 8 months out of the year.
That'll be grounded out the middle and booted there by Goss. A good throw from Shelton Gitson. That should be an E1F. Excuse me, E3F. Can't get my numbers right. So Goss dropped the play. I mean, you see Shelton, good composure, throw over. Maybe a little low, but still should have made the play there at first base. It was there for him. UNCG just making it tough on themselves today, honestly.
The catcher, Max West.
Defense hasn't been quite as crisp as they usually want.
And maybe that's because they're playing a doubleheader. I mean, you don't want to use it as an excuse, but sometimes mentally you can check out in times if you're playing a game for 5-6 hours straight.
And right.
Not really what you want to see, but sometimes it does happen.
Like we were talking about with Matt Frisbee earlier in the start, as much as you think these guys can stay locked in for that amount of time, they're human. They're going to.
Yep, exactly right.
They're going to have plays like that. It's hard to stay, like you said, it's hard to stay focused for that long of amount of time.
That's what makes college baseball as much of a mental game as it is a physical game. There's so much working against you in every aspect, and you got to stay locked in. You got to stay on edge at all times. And that's going to get down through the right side, but Cost makes a nice stab there to get the final out. And we're headed to the bottom of the eighth. Spartan looking to score some runs. They trail this one 10-4. You're watching UNCG Baseball on the SoCon Digital Network.
In the eighth inning for the Tigers, they score one run.
The road to Omaha begins in Greenville, South Carolina. The Southern Conference Baseball Tournament comes to Fluor Field May 23rd through 28th. Enjoy some great college baseball with a trip to the NCAAs on the line in a city the New York Times calls one of the top places to go in 2017. Get your tickets to the tournament and book your rooms in, yeah, that Greenville today. Experience the games. Explore the city.
These are the student athletes. This is where they train. These are their homes. This is where they become Rhodes Scholars and academic All-Americans. These are the athletes they've always admired. This is where champions are crowned and moments are made. This is the Southern Conference.
And welcome back to UNCG Baseball Stadium as we get set to start the bottom of the eighth frame. Due up for VCU, it looks like this. It's going to be Webster, Goss, Jacobs. Combined, one for nine.
Caleb Webster.
Oddly enough, UNCG has been really good in weird spots. One through three, each have a hit. Eight and nine have a combined three hits. It's that four, five, six, and seven with a combined one hit. It's really kind of in the undoing. Webster, of course, with the only hit of the day in that group, came in the sixth inning, a single. The 1-0. Into center it goes, and that'll be out number one to Danny Bear.
The first baseman, number 18, Michael Goss.
I'll bring up Michael Goss. Goss 0 for 3 today, a 271 average on the year. He's been one of the better hitters for UNCG in this early part of the season, going through a little bit of a downswing right now, though. The pitch on its way, low, outside, ball one. Let's get a check in on see how those lady softballers are doing in just a moment. As that pitch will be popped up, and drifting back is the catcher, and that will be just out of play.
Hey, you gotta have that.
Four. Strike one.
Mark would add that.
As parents are making jokes below, as it seems like one of the parents missed a play. That pitch will be well outside for a wild pitch, ball two. UNCG taking on Campbell in the capper of the UNCG Invitational. They lead it 6-1 in the bottom of the fourth. That pitch will be in there for strike two, 2-2 to Goss. For the Spartans, it looks like Bouplon had another good day in the circle. Four innings pitched, three hits, one run, as that's going to be grounded to the shortstop. Lee Tyson throw over to first in time for out number two. She gave up one run. That one run was earned. Three walks. And one extra base hit.
Designated hitter, Trey Jacobs.
Drop her ERA down to 4-4-2. For the hitters, it seems to be another good day for Gabby Cubbage.
Cubbage,
party in the Cubbage. One hit. Two at-bats, two ribbies, 1K. And that pitch will be fouled off, being out of play.
Look out in there, Princeton.
I don't think they can hear you.
I got to say it louder, I guess.
Don't scream in the microphone. It would hurt my ears.
Well, that's why I wasn't trying to hurt your ears. I wanted to let them know, Scott.
That was very polite, but it did not help the safety of anybody.
Well, anyway, we digress. 1-1 count.
It's not 1-1 count anymore. It's a base hit.
That's a foul ball. 1-2.
1-2. See, got ahead of myself, Dan. You got me off my game. I was locked in. I was in the zone. Now you're interrupting me and saying weird things. Just can't get focused.
Hey, it's just part of it. I mean, when you're not on your game, you got to grind through it, right?
That's right. You got to lock in and get after it. Speaking of which, special shout out to our friend, Tony Hermain. We were very, very hungry after game one of this doubleheader, and he went and got us pizza like a loving friend would do.
He did. And he deserves a gold star today.
We are very thankful for that from our corporate sponsor, Papa John's, in the hizzy.
The official pizza sponsor of UNCG Baseball Press Box.
We should put their name on the back.
We could.
We should talk to our people about that. See if we can make that happen. Maybe Peyton Manning can come, too, and cut the ribbon for that ceremony. That pitch will be outside for ball three.
I don't know what else he's got going on right now.
He's probably not doing much. It's now 7-1.
Might as well tweet at him.
Yeah. We can tweet at whoever we want.
We can. Really thought earlier today, well, if you don't know, those in the Greensboro area, Bobby Bones is performing stand-up comedy tonight as Trey Jacobs draws a walk, and Scotty had the great idea to try to tweet at him today to see if he can come on, hop on, and do a little broadcasting with us, because obviously you guys probably are at least sick of me talking, because I did the first game by myself, second one, and bearing with Scotty here trying to figure it out, but I'm sure you wouldn't mind it hearing a professional hop on here, even if we would have peppered in a little bit of baseball and just let him talk for a while, it might have been a little more entertaining. For
there's no doubt about that. We might have even got some new fans of the broadcast.
Could have.
Maybe fans of Bobby Bones himself hopping on and boosting our ratings through the roof. As it is, gearing close to, I think, sweep week is coming up. We got to get our ratings up for sweep week. we got to get some more dollars through the system. It's now a 1-1 count to Ryan Sigmund. Runner on at first base for the Spartans.
Every time his walk-up song comes on, I think of the conversation you had with yourself on Tuesday about how that music video is just a bunch of dancing marshmallows.
Yeah, I got to figure out what the song is actually called so I can look it up and show it to you one day. I just don't know what the song is actually called. Maybe I'll ask Samantha over there next door what it is. So the song is called Alone. Let's see if we can pull it up as we're in the middle of this game. It's a 1-2 count. Ooh, that looked good. But instead called ball two. So 2-2. Deuces wild on the scoreboard. Yeah, the song is actually called Alone by Marshmallow, which is maybe why they're dancing in marshmallows.
That makes sense. But shouldn't there only be one marshmallow?
A slow tapper to the pitcher. Throw over to first in time, and that will do it. UNCG goes down without a harm in the bottom of the eighth inning. We're headed to the top half of the ninth. UNCG is going to need some more runs to win this one. They trail 10-4. You're watching UNCG Baseball on Spartans on SoCon Digital Network.
With Subway Catering, featuring good-to-go boxed meals with a side and freshly baked cookie, crowd-pleasing giant subs, and piled-high sandwich platters overflowing with flavorific choices. All made the way you say with everything you love, like jalapenos and chipotle southwest sauce. Subway Catering is simple and satisfying, a great value for any budget. Just call 877-360-CATER or visit subway.com and let us take care of any occasion. Subway, cater fresh.
Some of the changes I've seen myself since I've been here at UNCG is just, I've been really challenged. I've been really encouraged to come out of my comfort zone.
As a professor, what I feel is most important is to find that passion.
Do you have this dream of doing something bigger for the world, but you don't know how to get there? This is the place where you go to figure it out.
Welcome back to the UNCG Baseball Stadium. Same pitcher on the mound as before, Travis Tuttle, junior right-handed option, out of Winston-Salem, North Carolina. And Dan has finally gotten to enjoy Alone by Marshmallow now. Now he fully understands as Marshmallow is breaking it down on our screen, PJ style. Now you know what Ryan Sigmund is thinking about when he gets to the plate. He's thinking about dancing marshmallows.
Apparently wants to be a DJ.
Last
year's walk-up song was Roses by the Chainsmokers. This year it's a Marshmallow Guy. So it's a little different genre of music.
Got a good taste in music, I would say. Now somebody is imitating the marshmallow. This is the wildest music video I've ever seen. Everybody's imitating the marshmallow. It's a bandwagon effect.
Oh, and the guys who were bullying him earlier in the video are feeling silly.
So the moral of the story is if you want to be cool, be a marshmallow. It won't be cool at first, but
it'll catch
join
on.
In.
It'll
everybody
catch on.
Everybody will join in. As a 1-1 count here to Lee Tyson. And that pitch will catch outside edge, strike two. Lee Tyson, a slick fielding Princeton Tiger. Has made a couple plays in the field that have made you go, ooh, ah. It's now 1-2. Out to 2-2, all even on the scoreboard. Princeton looking to get at least a share of the series win. As that'll be to the third base side. Webster scoops and throws in time for out number one. And that'll bring up number 8 for Princeton, Chris Davis, leadoff hitter. I wonder how often that is that both leadoff hitters wear number 8. That's what the case is today.
Left fielder, Chris Davis.
I mean, well, statistically, it's what, a 1 in 100 chance? 1 in 200 chance?
Yeah, I would imagine. It's not good.
Not great, Bob.
Statistic, Dan, though.
Nope. Check swing. Foul.
You got us on lock today. You got sports science, statistics on the fly. You're telling me made-up hit streaks over here,
which
are probably
history,
facts,
say.
But I got to call you on them just to make sure.
Which one was that?
The one about Moritz reaching base in
oh,
53
yeah.
of his
no,
56
that one,
games. Is that real?
It's 54 or 56.
See, you even know the better. You're so good, Dan. That's going to be a quick ground out to Shelton. Throw it to first in time for out number two.
I just know he's only not reached base in 2 games. He had one, like the third game of his freshman season, he didn't get on base because he ended the year with like a 37-game reach base streak. That's ridiculous.
And that's good, right?
I mean, you want base runners on.
See the play here. It's actually going to be Webster making the play. Throw over to first well in time. So two back-to-back plays from Webster. It's almost like you look at their stats all the time.
Something like that.
Is that what your job is?
Kind of.
Oh, my bad. Well, sorry for calling you out.
That's all right.
It's a 1-0 count here to Bear. That'll be in there for strike one. So 1-1 count. Two away. Bear home run that mammoth shot over the right field fence. Back in the fourth. That's his one hit of the day, as that's going to be in there for strike two. How about this day? He is 1-for-3 with a pair of strikeouts, also two walks. That's a very involved gay. You go bomb K walk. That's what you do. He just
they
struck out again.
But reached base on the wild pitch.
So that would have been the end of the inning. But alas.
It is not.
So Danny Bear plays bomb K walk. I've heard of bomb K, but throwing the walk there, now you got three options.
The first baseman, number 10, Zach
makes your
Belsky
odds much less in your favor. There's three choices. Your odds go way down. That'll bring up Zach Belsky, a .240 average. Runners on, .222. His first pitch he sees in there for strike one. Due up for the Spartans to turn this thing around will be 9-1-2. That group is a combined 3-for-9. That'll be in the dirt. 4-1. 1-1 the count. Bear takes a minor lead over at first base. The pitch popped up into left field. Coming over is Trejo, and he will make the play to end the top of the ninth. Spartans looking to rally and rally in a big way. They trail this one 10-4, headed to the bottom of the ninth. You're watching UNCG Baseball on the SoCon Digital Network.
The Tigers, no runs, no hits, no errors, one runner left on base.
Hi, I'm Barbara Corcoran. To sell your home on time for the most money, you need a sharp agent with a marketing strategy that creates the most demand. Bottom line, you need a partner willing to put their own money on the line for you. In Greensboro and Winston-Salem, it would be Jason Bramblett. He attracts hundreds of buyers and creates so much demand that Jason can guarantee if your home doesn't sell at a price and deadline you agree to, he will buy it. Partner with the agent I trust. Go online or call and get your home sold.
Human beings can be hungry anytime they please. Maybe you messed up and didn't eat enough lunch. Perhaps dinner is very far away. It doesn't matter. Come to Arby's and solve your hunger problems with dollar sliders, cookies, small size fries, drinks, and shakes, each for a dollar from 2 to 5. P.M., not A.M. Arby's, we have the meats.
And welcome back to UNCG Baseball Stadium. We have a pinch hitter on deck. It's going to be number 25, left-handed pitcher Zach Kuchmanner. 29, Zach Kuchmanner.
This will be Kuch's first plate appearance for UNCG, as he has appeared in, I don't know, like 10 games on the mound? I should probably know that one, but I don't. Yeah.
You know, I want this to be known right now. I got a bone to pick with you, Dan. So if we go into the game notes right here, handy dandy game notes, and let's see, let's look for a roster page. Let's see, Zach Kuchmanner.
We're going here. All right,
Zach Kuchmanner, he finally has it filled in, but at the beginning of the season, you refused to put what position bat left-handed pitchers and right-handed pitchers would bat. And all of a sudden, we're in a situation where a left-handed pitcher is batting. I just wanted to know this was going to happen. I told you, and you said no.
You said I should be advised. At the time, Zach was just a left-handed pitcher. Since then, things have changed. Zach was given a bat, and now he's a two-way player position guy. I'm not sure what position he's going to be playing in right now. But that is the only change that has happened.
Well, I just wanted to let you know that is always a possibility every baseball team.
I didn't say it wasn't.
Just saying. Just saying. Sean Doolittle of the A's was drafted as a position player, and all of a sudden he's a pitcher.
Okay, that's different at that level. At that level, you're just looking to stay in baseball. So you're going to go wherever you want to.
Well, this guy's looking
or
to get
play
into
wherever
the game.
You need to.
All I know is that I'm right.
Yes, you were. Scott was right. Dan was wrong.
Yes.
Well done, Scott.
The crowd, the press box is going crazy right now. Is this going to be a swing and a miss? Strike three, and I don't think it would have mattered if you put his position in there or not. That was not a good AB. That'll bring up the leadoff hitter, Austin Embler.
This second baseman.
It looks like he's doing the stanky leg on TV. A pitch on its way in there for strike one.
Princeton with a new pitcher on the mound, Keller. Now throwing, it's his first appearance of the series.
His first appearance, but he has made another appearance. He's got 2 1/3 inning on the year. One hit, one run. That run was earned. One walk, 3 Ks on the season. Opponents are batting. Can't find that on the sheet. As that'll be up the middle, charging hard will be the second baseman, but unable to make the play as Embler is swift afoot to get to first. Phillips did everything he could to make that play, unable to get there. Bring up Tripp Shelton.
Tripp Shelton.
1-for-4 on the day, a 327 average on the season. Look at that tapper. Phillips charged hard. It just kind of died in the grass there real quick. Have to adjust to that one. Shelton sees the pitch in there for strike one. 0-1 count, one away. Keller will settle, throw over to first. Low, getting back in time is Embler. The pitch from Keller, high, outside, ball one. So 1-1 count here, one away. In the bottom half of the ninth inning, Spartans looking to make a major charge to get back into this one. It'll be in the dirt, ball two. Dan, we kind of talked about it earlier that this UNCG team doesn't have a whole lot of pitching, so evening up the series tomorrow would be a big task for this offense and this pitching staff. This will be fouled off and out of play for strike two.
Yeah, they're really hoping to get a good quality start from their horse, Matt Frisbee, today, but that one, unfortunately, was not the case. And tomorrow is we start the final game of the series as Shelton hits that one down the right field line. Should be extra bases, well, at least for Embler. Embler goes first and third on the play.
Extra bases for somebody. Yeah, I think the starter tomorrow for UNCG is listed as TBA.
Yep, that one's not right confirmed now. Who we're going to be throwing tomorrow, as we had talked a little bit earlier that I'm not even sure if we're going to play tomorrow. Softball went canceled.
Softball's already done, but it looks like the weather forecast may be cleared up for the Spartans. My guess, it may be a guy named John E. Holstaff. Get through that one, which could be tough.
Mm-hmm.
It's 9 innings, you got to get out of your bullpen. Moritz will come up now with one away on runners on the corners. One good thing you do have working for you is you don't have a midweek game this week.
Right, and Spartans return to action on Thursday against Lafayette in another 4-game series, like what we have with Princeton right now.
That'll be a swing and a miss. Strike one. So it should be a 1-1 count. It's a Moritz. The pitch on its way, high, ball one. Ball two, excuse me. I get my ones and twos mixed up a lot, apparently. I feel like I should have gotten that relieved in elementary school.
You would have thought.
I'd think so, but didn't work out that way. Took me a lot longer to tie my shoes than my fellow classmates as well. That pitch will be high for ball three.
Which I don't know if our listeners have heard this theory, as the Hall of Famer Dasha Iams has tried pointing out to us. You know this one, Scotty. If you tie your shoes backwards.
I don't believe that. I don't think this is a thing.
Well, Morris hit the chopper over short for an infield single.
RBI.
And an RBI.
And all of a sudden, the lead is down to five. You're starting to get in a situation where if you bring in a reliever,
Cesar Trejo,
you might get a save. Looks like we're going to have a pitching change here as pitching coach for Princeton comes out. Let's see if they'll make the move.
Anyway, back to this tying your shoes backwards thing. Apparently, I don't even know how to explain it.
How do you tie your shoes backwards?
You tie them normal, but then instead of going, say, if you're doing the loops and you loop towards yourself, you loop away from yourself and around and pull it back through.
See, I do just two loops and swoosh them around.
You do loop, swoop, and pull kind of guy?
I guess. I have two loops. I don't loop around things.
You got to loop around the loop. No. Oh, you got your two loops in your hands, right?
Yep.
So you got to loop around a loop.
Oh, okay, yeah.
There it is.
Yeah. I'm not doing loop-de-loops, though, and pull, whatever that is.
That's loop, ball swoop, one and pull. Trejo. I think that's Big Daddy, isn't it?
No.
Pretty sure that's from Big Daddy.
You're talking to a guy that barely knows how to tie his shoes because I learned in third grade.
Well, anyway, if you tie them backwards, apparently they never come untied. I had an issue with that. I tried doing it, couldn't figure it out. Mentally, the brain just could not like figure it out. And then
see, we're not in the Hall of Fame. That's why we can't
we are
do
not.
It. We can't do it because we're not in the Hall of Fame. And nobody's going to give me that phone call anytime soon, or ever. It ain't happening. A 1-1 count. Dasha, of course, a member of the Pfeiffer Hall of Fame, one of their standout softball players. Legend. As the Hawks, I think they are.
I think so.
Hawks.
Some type of bird. Pretty sure their record book over at Pfeiffer is called the Dasha Iams record book.
That's a good name.
As she was a two-way player, pitched and hit, and I've never actually looked at it, but I'm going to say she set records in everything.
every category and everything. They actually stopped keeping track after her 4 years.
Yeah.
They're just like, it's done. We have a second out of the frame, and it'll all come down to Caleb Webster here. Webster gets a hit or on base, the game will continue. If he doesn't, game's over. And it looks like he will not get that hit as he'll fly out to Bayer, and that will do it. Princeton will win this one 10-5 to improve to 2-5 on the year. The two wins came against the Spartans. UNCG with the loss will fall to 7-8 on the year, and the results will be pretty simple. The starters will earn the wins and the losses. Ben Gross will move to 1-0 on the year. Matt Frisbee will drop to 3-1 on the year. And the Spartans will look to come back and respond tomorrow and salvage a split in the series. First pitch in that game will be set for 1 p.m. unless things change. There is pending weather, so please keep abreast to UNCGSpartans.com and UNCG Sports Twitter handle, as well as UNCG Baseball, to keep up to date on all those scheduling needs. But it's been our pleasure for Dan Walker, Scott Wyatt, everybody back in the truck, Tony Hermain, Timothy, and Charisma. Once again, we'll see you next time. You've been watching UNCG Baseball on the SoCon Digital Network.